Gary McIntosh of Norwood to join them in the Senate Square for Pastoral Lectures in the Foundation Cup, Grand Final of 1991. $7,500 in prize money to the winner and $10,000 to the runner-up.
No worries, PC. Yes, conditions good here at Football Park. Crowd around 10,000 people as we experience some win in the commentary position. At this stage, we are yet to identify the culprit.
Spilly box that we've got up here at the moment. And I'm reeling under the conditions here in the commentary box.
Yes, well, Gary McIntosh has just won the toss for the Norwood side. He's elected to kick to the river end. Yes, mate.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Football Park Stadium for Nine's live coverage of the 1991 Foundation Cup between South Adelaide and Norwood. $17,000 up for grabs for the victor of this game and $10,000 for the runner-up. Joining me in commentary is Neville Roberts and Rick Davies. And Rick, former South Adelaide coach, how do you see this game going?
Yes, it's going to be a very interesting game tonight, Kim. Beautiful conditions, as you mentioned. Not a breath of wind. 10,000 or so people down here. Very, very good feeling, especially up here in the box. Ready for the first bounce. But South Adelaide, like I can see, you can see in your screen there, Johnny Reid. He'd be a bit confident tonight, but I'm going for South tonight. I think their forward lines, they've just shown enough in these games, and I'm going for South.
Neville Roberts, former captain of Norwood. How do you see the game panning out?
Well, South Adelaide, a lot of experienced players. I think they've got a little bit more in height around the ground, able to control the ball. It'll depend on their runners. But Neil Craig, in your screen, with Chairman of Selectors Philip Gallagher, is very clever. He's shown himself to be a good coach early, and I'll tip Norwood by 1-10.
Well, I'm selecting the Panthers. The umpires officiating tonight are Laurie Argent and Richard Williams. Laurie, the more experienced of the two umpires, has the football. The game is about to commence. The 1991 Foundation Cup Grand Final. Norwood versus South Adelaide. John Hall versus Darryl Heath. The ball touches the terra firma as Hall wins the tap. The ball comes to ground. It's tumped forward again by Hall. Now out towards Mello. He's a very good player. He's a class act. He puts it out towards Aish. Couldn't quite bend the back to get down to that one. Naley is there. The ball out towards Bowman. Lachlan Bowman puts it around his body. Paul Page from behind. Reddit the better. Going out there strongly is Schmid. He taps the ball off the ground. Page is in the hunt once more. He kicks it off the ground and the ball is out of play across the half forward line.
Very good opening, Kimbo, especially that centre bounce. Big John Hall ran right through Big Heath and he'd be feeling a little bit sore around the leg section.
As I said earlier, I think South Adelaide have an advantage in the big men. John Hall and Heath picking each other up behind play in ruck. First to ground. There's a good knockdown there by Jonathan Ross. He's in the action again. There's McIntosh. Tried to throw one out. Kepler around the body with his left foot. It's high underneath it. Taking a good mark for the Red Legs. Here's Binder. Just forward of centre wing. Grandstand side. He'll push it in long. And does. Just forward of the square. They set themselves, but it's all South Adelaide. And Schmidt behind. Good defender. Can play it either end of the ground. In fact, that's Grummet. He was named at centre-half forward for the Panthers. Troy, short to Bennett, the skipper. He'll have a look. Plenty of experience there, and they've got plenty of in their side. Smart from behind, but he's too late on the scene. In front, doing it better, is Halfpenny.
Warren Halfpenny has a look down the ground, puts it towards the outer side. Bowman at the back of the pack. It's a chance for the crumb. So too is Mello. He's pushed into the ground. Keith Thomas is there. Darryl Heath likewise. Over the top is Battams, and he's rewarded for his efforts. We've had just over 1.5 minutes of the opening quarter. It's a wobbly kick forward. Zimmerman couldn't take it. Woodlands can. He's an opportunist as he puts it around on the left boot. It's a wobbly kick, and the mark has been taken by Andrew Brockhurst. Started on the halfback flank and on the wing for South Adelaide many seasons ago before chancing his arm in the AFL with Fitzroy. And he did experience some success across the border. He'll be kicking from about 45 metres out. He's a right footer. Puts it to the head of the square. Players set themselves. Halfpenny front position and completes the easy mark.
No contest there from David Steffel, and Reid wouldn't be happy about that. It was pretty obvious where the ball was going to finish. No breeze on the ground, so it's pretty easy to judge. Halfpenny comes grandstand side. Hall decides to go for the big fist. The crumb is McIntosh, no result.
Yeah, you can see in your screen there, Macker. He'd be very keen to do well. And, of course, Darren Troy coming across from Geelong this year. He'd be equally trying to impress tonight. And this is shaping up to be a hard, tough game.
That clash in the centre, as Kim said on the news service, will be a very interesting one. It might have a fair bit to do with the result of the game as well. Binder gives it to McIntosh. Back to Halfpenny. The legs come away with it. They run through half back towards the centre of the ground. Dillon there gets a punch away from Jonathan Ross. Quickly, Kepler too high. Free kick has to be, and Laurie Argent agrees with me. The first time for everything? Not really. Good umpire, one of South Australia's most experienced. David Kepler, his experience too, as he punches it in with that left boot. Over half forward it goes. Oh, big jump from behind. That's Zimmerman. Gives it off quickly to the agile David Payne. He doesn't get a very good kick away. Kepler in everything at the moment. He'll go back on his left foot. Malloy read it well. That should be almost holding the ball. Not quite. Out of bounds, centre wing in the eastern side of the boundary.
Very good thing for the umpires tonight. They're not paying the easy free. I think that everything's come their way. They've sort of decided to give a free. But it's been very good umpiring decisions so far.
Only two free kicks so far as the handball comes out from Mello back towards Payne. That's his second kick for the game. Dewhurst, the two number fives, leads in the chase opposed to Tanner. Gets a handball away, not an effective one. Through solidly is Kepler. Picked up by Payne once more. This will be his third possession. He lifts the eyes. He's inside 50. He's normally very accurate, but oh, gee, you don't see that too often, Rick.
Yes, well, it was a bit unfortunate there. He streamed out of the centre of the ground where two South Adelaide players clashed, but he should have certainly finished off that play.
Schmidt from full back, short. Finds Troy, he's well up. McIntosh not near him at the moment. Now it's Dillon. He'll have to get rid of it and does. Late tackle, but that's okay. Good punch from behind. Binder backwards to Balm. Playing at half back. He pushes it in high. Tanner sets himself. He's up. He's high. That's Brett James, in fact, couldn't hold it. Michael Whitford, plenty of experience, chips it around, keeps it close to the boundary line, and that's finally where it'll end up.
Yes, a number of these South Adelaide players. Of course, Warhurst is playing for Norwood. You can see number 26 there ripping across there is Bickley. So there's a number of great players here playing tonight.
There's a first time for everything. Rick, it does appear that both sides have lined up as named in this morning's paper as the handball comes out from Binder across to Thomas. It's a nice centering kick, but it's well taken by Whitford. The hands were quick but not accurate. Ross tries to capitalise, couldn't do so. It's socketed off the ground by Schmid out towards Marty Dillon. He lost it. Payne says thank you. Gets another kick. In fact, that's his fifth possession. He puts it up high and underneath it, the man you should never leave by himself, Michael Aish.
Yes, well, magnificent play there by Payne. He could have just blasted away at the goal, but he didn't, and he was caught off balance a little bit, but he saw Michael Aish out onto the left side, and a beautiful placement to put Michael Aish in a good position.
Payne missed one from a similar position on the run. Aish has a set shot, and he did not even make the distance, and the mark has been paid. Lachlan Bowman, and no one even contested for that. Now Bowman will play on, opens the face of goal and bangs through the red legs first.
Yes, well, a magnificent mark by Lachlan Bowman and the finish off play. There you can see him in your screen, number 29, Lachlan Bowman, a country boy. And here you can see Michael Aish. Beautiful, usually a very, very good kick for goal. And look at the South Adelaide players. They thought it was just going to go through, and you can see Stephen Schmidt thinking, well, it should have been a point. But Lachlan Bowman just moved out slightly and put through Norwood's first goal, and a beautiful mark.
Indeed they did. And the only change to that lineup in the advertiser this morning, Kim, was that Dewhurst and Tanner will line up on the wings, and Mello and Battams opposite sides. At the bounce, Hall on this occasion, Thomas quickly out of the centre. That's the sort of style that Craig likes. Quick hands, quick movement of the ball. And they'll have to do that tonight with the taller players from South Adelaide. It's Whitford now from half back, puts it over to centre wing, eastern boundary. Through strongly Zimmerman. Rockhurst finally has it. Now Troy gets out of the pack, gets it back again from Bennett. That was good play. With strength, gets through. Just a chip to Naley. Gets lost on his left. Back to half forward is good. Well, that's Gary Cameron. And put the shiny oil on. He'll be easy to pick up tonight as he pushes it into the forward pocket. Good punch away by Sheldrick on Steckel. Finally coming away with it. It was Mello. He got it to Zimmerman. He gets it back again. Damien Mello. It's high. Far side. Lachlan Bowman up. But finally, good knock to the boundary.
And don't forget, at 8.30 tonight, Super 66 and Saturday Cross Lotto draws at 8.33, National 9 News Break, and at 8.35, Hey Hey, It's Saturday.
From the throw-in, Thomas, quick hands, back to Payne, under a lot of pressure, the loose ball, Bickley. Comes back, and it looked like Dillon had got the kick in. High ball over the top of Woodlands. Good tackle on him. Smart gets the crumbs. He pushes it in high. Steckel and Sheldrick do battle. Steckel!
Yes, well, what a magnificent mark there under tough opposition from young Childrick. He's done a superb job throughout these Foundation Cup games. But Stokel in front, big powerful man, and that's exactly what South Adelaide want him to do. And on that occasion, he just did that.
A chance to get the Panthers within 1 point. In he comes, shouldn't miss from there. His first, and the Panthers 6 points.
Yes, well, you can see him there on your screen. He's about 6'5". Bounced over the top. Woodlands almost caught holding the ball, but here's Smart back from the Crows, playing up forward tonight, putting the ball with a magnificent kick right into the square, and there he is, the big fella Steckel. Anger Island killer in front, and a beautiful mark under tough opposition, as I said, and put through a magnificent goal.
Back centre field. Norwood enjoying a one-point advantage, 1-1 opposed to South Adelaide, one goal. Conditions absolutely perfect here at Football Park. Umpire Richard Williams with the football. John Hall opposed to Darryl Heath. Hall won the tap. It's pushed forward by Naley. He's trying to play for possession. Smart, quick hand back to Troy. Gets the kick towards the outer flank. Zimmerman underneath it. Batham's made up valuable meterage. But Mello, he's had a number of touches. This time it's an educated hand pass out to McIntosh. Likewise back to Mello. He drives it in long around the 50-metre mark. Oh, Page ran himself under the ball. Aish, super quick hands, but it went to Marty Dillon. Oh, all in his back by Lachlan Bowman. Play on the call. McGregor Grummet is there. So too is Payne. That is clever work. Centres the ball nicely. Getting back underneath it. Pike. But Kapler, experience, coolness and calmness under pressure, punches the ball over the line.
Yes, well, you can see then Neil Craig. He'd be starting to chew his chewy pretty heavily there on the right-hand side, the new coach. But Norwood shaping up pretty well in this first quarter. A good even contest.
Indeed it is. From behind, Jonathan Roche, ace, chip around the corner. Knew he was off balance, didn't want to send it over the boundary line on the full, so he just chipped one along the boundary.
There on your screen is big Michael Whitford, centre half back. Good contest tonight between Jonathan Ross. There he is, about 6'4" or 5", and shaping up to be a future centre half forward star for Norwood.
Indeed, and on the youth loose for the Crows as James puts it in high. Under the ball, off, nudged out a little bit. Smith on Pike. No free kick, plenty of experience there. So it's Smith on the far side. The kick is good, he finds Troy. He's got the better of McIntosh at the moment. On to Page, his left foot will go towards centre wing. Zimmerman in the race, bad bounce from behind. It was Brockhurst, underground from McIntosh to Mello, but there's a free kick. And umpire Williams picked it out. Brockhurst has got it, he'll send the Panthers forward. Decides to go right along the line. McIntosh underneath it, Woodlands! Not quite, McIntosh. Crumbs. The kick is a shocker from Macca and possibly went to the boundary line. Had nothing to go to. Lachlan Bowman now. He'll put it back towards half forward. Jonathan Ross from behind. Couldn't quite take it. Whitford will help out there. Coming in late is Dillon. Around the corner. Dillon again to ground. But it's finally Michael Whitford. He'll clear for the Panthers.
Ball is high, from behind is John Hall, two grabs, he takes the mark, plays on quickly as most ruckmen do. The handball went back towards McIntosh, he drives it in low and long, and he nearly found Michael Ace, just couldn't quite control it. Dewhurst paddles the ball forward, chance for McGregor Grummet, he's over the top, can he pick it up? He can, gets rid of the ball quickly, back there is Binder, been pretty solid in defence, picks it up, he's on the left boot, great smother by McGregor Grummet.
Yes, well, the conditions tonight, grand final, both sides are going to be a little bit nervous, and a couple of real bad pickups, but a couple of real good smothers, and you can see there in Football Park, beautiful conditions.
You're live on Nine's Wide World of Sports as Thomas gets a kick away. It's to the open spaces, a race for pace. Dillon, the first man there, has a little bit of room to work with. Gets the ball, hooks it around his body. Oh, great anticipation, Brett James. It was poor play by McGregor Grummet. Tanner went through. Thomas back towards McIntosh. Educated hand pass, a brilliant one, in fact, to find James, who spears out a pass to Aish, pinned to the boundary line. Gets the ball back to Lachlan Bowman. 35 metres out, he's kicked one. But this is a wobbly ball, and it lands in the waiting arms of Paul Page.
Paul Page, short. Goes to Smith. Beautiful hit forward, but Damien Mello read it better than anybody. He'll get around Baddams. He'll line up the goals. He'll send it in. It'll hit the front of the square. Lachlan Bowman, there he's got it!
Well, what a magnificent mark. And you can... And Darren Troy was the partner coming down from the centre. Look at the way that he kept his eye right on the football. Although I don't think that he really controlled the ball the whole time. I think he only just took the mark. Very good mark.
And that's his second.
Yes, well, a bit of very good play there by Norwood, bringing the ball into the forward lines very, very sharply, crisply. And a bit of a mistake there by the South Adelaide player, but there he is, Lachlan Bowman. About 6 foot four or five, young Damien Mello is playing a tremendous game. Mello out on the outer side, and he fired the ball into him. You can see a lot of pushing and shoving, and there in your screen, Lachlan Bowman taking a very good mark and finishing the play off.
2 goals, one opposed to 1 goal, Norwood in front. They are kicking to the left of screen, the northern end of Football Park. There is a slight breeze favouring that end as Heath wins the tap. It goes out towards Matthew Baddams. He fists the ball forward. Likewise, Brockhurst. A little bit of volleyball out there as the ball is moved forward. Tanner, quick hands out towards James. He put Warhurst under enormous pressure. Smart punches the ball forward, but a free kick will go the way of the rugged veteran defender, Tom Warhurst. Puts the ball down towards centre-half forward. Whitford took front position. Off hands, Dillon. The handball is astray. Bowman, he's like salt and pepper. He's in everything at the moment, but he couldn't get that kick. Cameron can get the handball out towards Troy. He puts it up high. Players set themselves. Warhurst from behind. Brockhurst, the better recovery. On the left boot, he'll have to get back onto the right. He decides to handball. Nailey tucked away in the pole. Oh, he fell over. Well, he stopped, he started, and he lost the ball and eventually was thrown over the line.
Well, we all know Mark Naley's absolutely quicksilver, but on that occasion he changed his mind, but the body didn't.
In your screen, Mark Naley. What a recruit for South Adelaide. Still plenty of football left in those legs. Barm will do the ruck work, gets it down. Warhurst has it. They'll have to push it out. That's the new rule. Cameron tries to get around. He's strong. He'll have a shot at goal now, but he'll be offline. 1 point only.
It's the last couple of games that I've seen young Cameron coming across from Geelong, of course, number three. He's been a bit slow, but he's slowly settling into our football over here and enjoying it, of course, with South Adelaide winning. And I think that you'll find that he'll be a very good player for the Panthers this year.
And on the other side of the ledger, the man kicking out, young Sheldrick, has been very quick to slot into senior football at fullback. The ball at the back of the pack, Bickley, the handball out to Woodlands, has to get onto the left boot, does it with class, held back on that kick, searching for Nailey in the pocket once more, tried to pirouette, Cameron tried to get it back, Nailey still over the top, farms out a hand pass, in there is Malloy, tackled, nearly decapitated, players dive in there, well that's holding the ball and that was quick. I tell you what, there are a number of players there and I agree with the free kick but not always the interpretation.
I suppose it's a matter of who's on the bottom of the pack and who's got hold of the football. And on that occasion, young Glenn Malloy was a little bit unfortunate, but the umpires have been instructed this year to give that as a free kick, and I suppose you've got to be consistent.
Yes, that's correct, Rick, and as I said, I agree with the rule, but the interpretation at times, a little suspect. Nevertheless, Cameron, kick number three. He has kicked 1 point. Make that 1-1.
I mentioned a couple of minutes ago that young Cameron shaping up to be a very good player. A few games that I have seen him, he has been a little bit slow. He's been caught. Look at the way he rips in after the football there. He keeps fighting for the ball. And, oh, well, Glenn Malloy was very unfortunate in the first case to be caught holding the ball. There he is. He tried to flick the ball out and only hit Woodlands. And really, in my opinion, he never really had the ball. But anyway, Cameron kicked a goal.
Hall. Against Heath, gets it again. Winning the rucks at the moment, Hall. From the centre, Payne to Tanner was good. They're forward, the Redlegs, but it's South Adelaide. If they can get a bounce, Page gets one. goes to ground. Ace with him. Play on's the call. He did knock it out. Troy, beautiful hands. Got it to Bickley. Cameron there. McIntosh with strength. Good work by Cameron, though. A chance for Jonathan Ross. Page desperate. Oh, McIntosh has gone berserk. Short. Thomas. Trip. Play on to advantage. James from 15 metres. Tip short. Payne with an opportunity. He shouldn't miss from there. He's normally very accurate, and that's a bad one.
Yes, well, a couple of times that we've seen Payne. He hasn't played a lot of football so far this year. He's very quicksilver, number 17 in your screen, and he's messed up the last couple. And Norwood, really, with the games very, very hard. And you can see Macca there. All he's trying to do is get the Guernsey off him, I think. But unfortunate for South Adelaide, well, unfortunately for Norwood, they missed that goal.
Rick, I thought Macca had a jackhammer in his hand then. The ball on the outer side. Punch from behind. Opportunity. That is intelligent football. Kapler on the run. Opens up, has a look, finds a bit of space, puts it out towards the pocket. Not the best way to go, but Sheldrick picks it up cleanly. And, in fact, has gone out of play. And that's left forward pocket at the southern end. We'll have a throw-in in front of the scoreboard. Nearly 18 minutes into the first term. Norwood 2-2, South Adelaide 2-1.
Yes, a very even game here so far in this first quarter. And it's very, very encouraging to see this. Both sides going flat chat at the ball.
Woodland's got it back out. Binder couldn't get it. Now let's have a look at Bennett. He's tight with the halfpenny. Malloy, not a lot of time out there at the moment, Rick.
No, there's not a lot of time, and both players, you can see here.
At 4:30 this morning, if you're an aim to get up, the Lipton's International Players Championship Tennis, live via satellite.
Yes, well, that'll be very interesting viewing, but we've got a lot of good viewing here with Norwood and South Adelaide in a lock battle.
Bickley towards the open goal, and like Payne at the other end of the ground, he's offline.
Yes, well, you would expect Payne, really, to finish the play off, but Bickley, a bit ordinary in his kick, but a very, very fit player, very, very good player, in my opinion. And a beautiful hands by Cameron on that occasion.
So, both sides making errors in front of goals. Brad Sheldrick has played all but one Foundation Cup, and as I mentioned before, he's done it in great style. A big leap from Malloy, couldn't take it. Good hands by Tanner. Back to Binder. He's been very solid in defence. Puts it up towards the grandstand wing. Jonathan Ross was pushed out of it. Dillon was underneath. Kapler picks up another possession. Kicks around his body over the head of Smart. In there is Bennett, the captain, and the ruck rover for the Panthers. Sweeping hand pass out towards Dewey. Dewey puts in a short pass, and he's found Brockhurst. So a lot of experience in that passage of play. Bennett to Dewhurst to Brockhurst and eventually to Cameron in the pocket.
Yes, well, you can see there, the poor little fella Cameron moving in. And I think they're just trying to brush a few things off of him. But no, beautiful there by Brockhurst first. And he's shaping up to be a great player at centre-half forward. And Cameron finishing off.
Gary Cameron, a very difficult angle. Four kicks and three handballs so far. We are 19 and a half minutes. He's put it out to the right. He had to start it a little more to the left. It's a point, though. It's a valuable point. It gives them the lead.
Indeed, it does. 14 plays 15. That's 2-2 to 2-3. South Adelaide. No breeze, so it doesn't matter which end they're going. Good punch by Smart to bring it to ground. Oh, halfpenny through. Beautiful tackle on him. That was by Cameron. Now Smart again. Binder over his head. Halfpenny there. Bickley will be right with him. No, he absolutely creams him. And that's a free kick. It might have been out in the full otherwise, but too high on that occasion.
Yes, it certainly was. And you can see here, Bickley picking up straight through him. Didn't mean to hurt him. I think he just meant to be in hard at the football, and quite rightly a free.
The bodies are going in hard, and one of their best players for South Adelaide was Kapler. Bone near the ball. Good kick short to find Smart. He's in the centre of the ground. Had a virus last week, but appears to have recovered from that. It's a beautiful leg. Up high, Steckel, but with him, Sheldrick got even higher. Halfpenny in again. Reckon he's not copping much. Brockhurst got it out. Cameron over to Dewhurst. He's tucked in the pocket. And it was always going to be too hard from there.
South Adelaide, when you mentioned, have got a couple of very good players. We've mentioned Naylor, of course. But the one that not a lot has been said about is Andrew Brockhurst coming back from Fitzroy. And the two games that he has played up at Mount Compass and again here tonight, he is showing that he is going to be a valuable player.
The ball put up high. Bone takes the ball. Oh, he should have fed it off towards Naylor. Eventually gets the kick away. Bone has replaced Darryl Heath, so they're changing the ruckman off the bench as Cameron picks up another possession. Steckel has the sit, but he couldn't take the mark. And that is well done by Zimmerman. We are into time on. The ball is transferred over towards Craig Barton. Has the luxury of a bounce. Now he has a look downfield. It's a long kick. The 2-11s, Matthew Baddams opposed to Mello. Mello on top in that individual battle. And the ball is taken out of play. Just a reminder, that Hey Hey, It's Saturday at the special time of 8:35.
A chance now for Troy as he paddles the ball along. Did it brilliantly to get it off of Payne. Gives it inside, looking for Cameron. Malloy will be with him, though. He'll run it to the boundary. You can bet everything you've got on that.
He's a very good player, Cameron. Shaping up to be very good. Troy, Naylor, Brockhurst. They've got a number of players up forward, South Adelaide. But Norwood, when they get hold of the football, and Neil Craig, I suppose his idea this year is to keep control of the ball and finish it off, and both sides doing well.
South in the lead by a point. Opportunity, Troy's getting plenty of touches. Brockhurst now, he'll chip it around. Steckel with it, Sheldrick in front. Might be in the back. No, it's not. First to it, Tanner up from the wing, and he'll take it over the line for a point.
Yes, well, young Sheldrick, after that first mark by Steckel, is starting to get in front because he is quite a big player. Steckel, 6'5", and Sheldrick doing a good job the last couple of times.
Halfpenny puts it to the outer side. Big Randall Boners there, couldn't take it. Crashing his way through is Zimmerman. He can't take it either. That is a brilliant hand pass by Woodlands to Batten. Now over the top to Cameron. He's been a live wire in the first term. He snaps around his body. The accuracy not there. South Adelaide move along to 2-5, Norwood 2-2. This has been a good quarter for the Panthers.
Yes, it certainly has been a good quarter as the first... as the siren goes to end this first quarter. Very, very even contest. Norwood and South Adelaide both.
So at quarter time, Norwood 2-2, 14 points, trailing South Adelaide 2-5, 17. We'll be back with the second quarter shortly. You're live on Nine. The Redlegs, 2 goals, 2-14, trailing South Adelaide, 2 goals, 5-17. After the first term, leading goal kickers for Norwood, Bowman has 2. For the Panthers, Steckel and Cameron have 1 apiece. And it is a good evening to Graham Campbell down on the boundary. And Graham, who was your selection for this game?
Well, firstly, good evening, Kim. It's great down here, absolutely great. And my selection, I've got to admit, I know they're 2 points in front at the moment, but I went for South Adelaide by 1-10.
I think you're a good judge tonight, Graham. They've had a number of good players. Yep. They've had 15 more possessions than Norwood
really?
Thus far. And one player that's causing havoc up forward is young Lachlan Bowman.
Well, he has shown something tonight, Bowman. I must admit, Kim, I had no great opinion of the lad, but tonight he's made me sit up and take notice. Nonetheless, it's been Cameron and Troy around the packs that has made the difference and got South back into the game, in my opinion.
Yes, there's no question they've had more of the football, but this lad, he's only a youngster, and we saw him take one strong mark. He also took a mark which was uncontested, but the most important thing is for Norwood that he did manage to convert. And at the other end, a man that's looking dangerous that perhaps has been down on form is Big Steckel.
Yeah, I believe, Kim, he should always play at full forward. I've often said this of David Steckel. He's a natural forward. He's a bloke that holds his ground well, as he did in that quarter, and he took the strong mark and kicked the long goal. He's one of the best kicks in the South Adelaide team, and long elongated arms. You like that? Elongated, I think, is the right pronunciation.
I think people know what you mean, Graham.
And he can take a mark, that's the main thing. And Steckler is a vibrant full forward.
Well, the game's about to recommence. It's now back to your commentator, Ken Cunningham.
Thank you, Kim. The start of the second quarter. Fantastic night here at Football Park as the umpire bounces the ball. That's umpire Laurie Argent. Goes towards the half forward flank, and a good mark taken by Smart. Plays on quickly outside the 50, up towards full forward. Steckel in front. Chevick. Steckel over the top. I think he's got a great goal, Steckel.
Yes, with Smart, magnificent player coming back from the Crows. A little bit lucky there. And Steckel, you've got Big Sheldrick doing everything right. And you can see here, beautiful movement by Smart. He really has got a little bit of ability. Sheldrick did everything right. Bit of a push there, and he took the first grab. Steckel picks it up and shoots through South Adelaide's third goal, and very, very quickly in this second quarter.
2 goals, 2 Norwood, South Adelaide 3-5. Signs are rather ominous for Norwood at this stage. If the Panthers start to take control of this game, in there working hard is Bennett McIntosh. Nearly gets his jumper ripped from his body. He politely hands the ball back to umpire Richard Williams, who is officiating with Laurie Argent tonight. John Hall in there, so too Randall Bone. Keith Thomas pulled off the ball. Naylee, very quick hands. That was slick work out towards Dewhurst. He puts in the pass up towards centre-half forward. Steckel takes it. He's dispossessed. Sheldrick throws him to the ground. Batten's off the ground. Oh, yes, there's the mark, and there's the goal to Brockhurst.
Great work by South Adelaide. Beautiful work by Naylor in the centre, and he's really going to be a star this year. What about him bringing him back from Melbourne? South Adelaide, what a coup. And Baddams, beautifully kicking the ball off the ground. Good thinking there. He couldn't pick it up because there are Norwood players all around. Jumped over the top of the pack. Beautiful kick down there. And look at Brockhurst. Good thinking, really, because he could have easily ran through the goals. Good work there, and he's a good player.
South Adelaide 4-5, Norwood 2-2, and the Panthers on fire. An happening of the second quarter, only 2 minutes in, and the two excellent goals to the Panthers. Umpire Laurie Argent, his co-umpire tonight is Richard Williams, and it's Laurie Argent, the man in the centre of your screen. But Richard Williams, his co-umpire, to me, has got a very, very big future in the game of umpiring. Bounce down, Hall, Bone is there, McIntosh. Players working well, McIntosh went in hard. And a couple of South Adelaide players don't like that, and Mac has given away a free kick.
Yes. Look at him there, saying what happened. But he's done a couple of things the last... Well, he went in with the arm, and he also went in with the head there. Only after the ball, though, Ken.
Up towards half forward, and a good mark to Tom Warhurst. Someone will have a headache tomorrow, I can tell you. Tom Warhurst plays on quickly. Back towards the centre of the ground it goes. Dillon is there. Over the top, Naylor, Baddams, Bennett. Gee, it's heavy stuff in the centre, I can tell you. Mac has got the football. Macca handballs out to Balm. Balm with a loose handball, doesn't cover much territory. Goes the way of Kapler. Kicks around his body. South back towards half forward. Well, that's got to be a free kick. Surely the good was not paid. I can't believe that. There's a kick by Halfpenny. Back towards centre wing. And Kapler, the left footer, takes the mark. Centre wing, grandstand side.
Well, that was near criminal. Mark Bickley should have had a free kick. That's kick number 6 to Kapler. He puts it back in the direction it came from. And there's a strong mark taken by Woodlands. Craig Woodlands, too far out to score, but he brings the ball back into play quickly. Oh, the umpire was in the way, and Tanner has a word. Troy took the mark, but Richard Williams, Rick, in the way, and that was unfortunate for Norwood.
Yeah, well, it was a bit unfortunate there because they saw Woodlands saw Troy move down into the centre of the ground. You can see here, there is Tanner. A bit unfortunate. I don't think that Troy would have missed the mark anyway.
Well, he certainly would have had to earn it if the umpire wasn't there, but he's kicked the goal, and this looks pretty dangerous for Norwood.
Well, the quarter started about 4 or 5 minutes ago, and South Adelaide are going from strength to strength. They've got players nearly in the centre, and you can see on your screen there that unfortunately the Tanner was a little bit impeded by the umpire there, but Troy went back. Beautiful kicker of the football, and 3 goals in 3 minutes. Spells a little bit of trouble for the Redlegs.
Well, it certainly does, Jumbo, that's for sure. But beautiful football by South Adelaide, and the very good crowd here at headquarters enjoying the contest. We're only 4.5 minutes into the second quarter, and the South Adelaide leading by 3-3. That'll bring a smile to the coach, John Reid's face, that's for sure. McIntosh sat upon by 2 South Adelaide players. He loses the football. Payne picked it up at the second attempt. A long kick towards centre-half forward. Off hands it goes. Pike with a chance. Kicked off the ground by Whitford towards the boundary line. Baddams there, and the ball is forced out of play. Oh, a bit of pushing and shoving. Tension high here, Jumbo, in the grand final.
Yes, well, that's good. A bit of pushing and shoving doesn't hurt anybody as long as someone doesn't get hurt. But a couple of weeks ago, Norwood were about 6 or 7 down, Ken, so I wouldn't worry. They can come back.
Tell you what, I'd be worried if I was the coach. South are looking pretty sharp. Payne tried to get the handball out. Jonathan Ross is yet to have a sniff in this game. In there is Whitford, and he's not the most attractive footballer, but he... Very hard to get kicks on, Jumbo.
Yes, well, Michael Whitford, centre-half back, he's wanting to do well, and he's going to be very hard to beat this year, Michael Whitford.
The ball punched down towards Bennett. He's caught on the left boot. He kicks around his body. John Hall in pursuit. In the way was Craig Balm. Now Hall gets the handball back towards Balm. Two of the slowest footballers on the ground, but they've kept the ball in the area, and now we'll have a throw-in.
And that was good umpiring there. Johnny Reid, he's saying now we're 4 or 5 in front, and he'd be pretty happy at this particular point of time, Ken.
Certainly would be, Jumbo, as John Hall got the tap away, but it's South Adelaide working hard. Bones to Baddams. Baddams towards centre-half forward. Thrown out by Brockhurst to Bickley. Here's an opportunity for Cameron. If the ball will sit for him, he shouldn't miss from here. I think he's kicked it. And in wait on the goal, umpire. It's home, a goal to the Panthers.
The young Cameron had to do something right. He's had a number of shots for goal in that first quarter. I think it was about 3. Beautiful movement there by Bickley. Out into the space. Never found the body. And Woodlands there really putting the heat on the Norwood players. And the goal umpire went right across. Beautiful long handball by Bickley out into the space. And there he is, Cameron, running in and making sure that he finished off the play this time.
Raining goals for South Adelaide in the early stages of this second term. They're on 6-5, Norwood 2-2 as the ball hits the ground, and Bennett picks it up once more as we approach the 7-minute mark. Opportunity for Halfpenny. He picks it up. The handball thought about Balm. Decide to go with Solo. Now the ball is up high. In there, Bennett late. Play on the call. Now a free kick. Play on advantage. Out towards one. I'm not sure if that was an advantage. It may work out to be. Ball is there. He goes to ground. The handball out to Glenn Malloy. Eventually, they find some space. It goes back to Tanner. Tanner puts it out. Ross is underneath. And in fact, that's Lachlan Bowman.
Good work there by Norwood side. And this young fella is shaping up to be a very, very good forward. I think that's the difference tonight. South Adelaide have got a lot of forwards, where this fellow, kicking two goals up to now, has been their only scorer.
He's taken three marks. This will be kick number six. He'll kick from just inside 50. It's not a strong breeze here at Football Park. It's not a bad kick off the boot. And he has snuck it through.
Michael Whitford and Stephen Smith are there, a little bit upset there. And you can see the goal umpire there. He's got a few words to say, which is great, because usually the umpires don't get too much to say. But the ball shot forward. Good mark by Lachlan Bowman. Mentioned a couple of minutes ago, shaping up to be their only forward. And you can see here, shot the ball. I thought it was going to go to the left. But there's the goal umpire. You can't get any closer than that. And really, number 21 in your screen there, I thought Michael Whitford was very close.
The goal umpire in the best spot as the bounce takes place. Bone gets the tap. Naylor goes in the second time. Tap it out cleverly towards Baddams. Baddams the handball off to Dillon. Dillon towards half forward. Looking for Woodlands in front. Almost a strong mark. Got it the second time, but was sat upon by a Norwood defender. And the ball is kept in the area. And umpire Argent will call for a bounce.
Well, McIntosh is putting an enormous amount of pressure on South Adelaide players, but they seem to be taking it. He's given Naylor one to go on with him at the centre, and on that occasion he ripped in quick, pretty smartly, and he's really throwing his body around.
Got to get the football, that's the most important thing, Jumbo. He hasn't got too much of the footy at the moment as Thomas gets a kick back towards centre wing. Baddams is there. Mello came in hard, the youngster, and the ball goes out of play.
And let's not forget at 8:30 the Super 66, followed by Saturday Night Cross Lotto Draw and National 9 News Break, plus Hey Hey at Saturday.
Thomas with a chance now, grubbers a kick towards the coaching box of Norwood, and it goes out of play. Ladies enjoying the evening, doing a bit of knitting, relaxing, have a wonderful time here at Footy Park.
And Ken, if you ever watch those ladies, as the game increases in tempo, so does their knitting rate. The ball pushed out towards Troy, in turn to Naylor. McIntosh in late, the kick is forward. Players set themselves, Smart is there, up high was Warhurst. The handball goes out towards Balm, playing in defence. He gets a kick towards the boundary line. He was seeking safety and he achieved that.
Yeah, well, I think you'll find that Norwood are trying to find a player up forward. They've got Lachlan Bowman, but they just seem to be under a little bit of pressure across that half forward line. The South Adelaide, especially Smart, he's putting in an enormous amount of pressure. I've got Naylor, Cameron, and I've got players all over the forward line winning their spot.
Kapler couldn't control it. He's still in there trying, though. Glenn Malloy came in. Strong body work. The ball is loose. Picking it up is Payne. He was tackled, and he will win a free kick for being held and not in possession. And Norwood desperately need goals at the 10-minute mark of this second term. $17,000 up for grabs in the grand final of the Foundation Cup. Kick number 10, that was for Payne. McIntosh pushed in the back. And umpire Richard Williams saw it that way. And Jumbo, if you take front position, you often get the free kick.
Oh, yeah, but he really did play for that. And Troy's starting to put a little bit of pressure on him. And I suppose he deserved that one.
Three kicks, four handballs to the Norwood captain as the ball is punched over the boundary line. And he's leading from the front. I agree with Ken. He's not getting a lot of the football, but he's certainly creating a little bit of urgency out there.
Yes, he certainly is. But I can see that South Adelaide are pretty well covering every line of the Norwood forward line. And Norwood are not really getting near. And you can see Troy. These are the blokes that are getting hold of the football. And they're making opportunities up forward for South Adelaide.
Troy to Cameron. Cameron towards the centre of the ground. A chance now for Woodlands. He's going to be a good player for the Panthers this year. Craig Woodlands kicks long into the square. It goes back to Goodmark to Steckle. That's a great kick by Woodlands. A penetrating kick and a good mark by Steckle.
Well, I'm having a lot of trouble with the big fella's name. Steckle from Kangaroo Island. I've got it right. It's only taken me 4 or 5 weeks. But Graham Campbell said at quarter time that this is the guy that he played full forward and he hasn't let them down.
And his third kick. He's kicked 2 goals. Has he kicked 3? One on the goal umpire. 3 kicks, 3 goals.
Great work there by the Channel 9 screen to see that Steckle putting the ball, but as Ken said, Craig Woodlands, very, very elusive player, very, very elusive player when let loose, and he fired the ball into the forward lines. And if you've got the one-on-one situation, whereas you had on that situation, you had Steckle kicking the ball beautifully. It looked like it was going to go to the left, but straight through for their 7.
South Adelaide, 7 goals, 5. Norwood, 3 goals, 2. A 27-point advantage. Umpire Richard Williams with the football. Nearly 13 minutes into the second term. Hall won the tap. The ball down to Cameron. One of the best for South Adelaide. One of the best on the ground. Over the top of that is Bennett. Tries to kick it out with his boot. Does so successfully. Well done, Bickley. The handball's astray, but he's put his side forward as Dewhurst grabs it. The handball in turn out towards Baddams. He hooks it back. He had a look for Steckle. Oh, up high. There was the leap from Brockhurst. Sheldrick back there. And the ball is over the line for a rush point. 7-6 to 3-2.
Another player that impresses me very much for South Adelaide is young Baddams, Ken. On the wing, he hasn't been beaten in the games that we've seen so far.
You're right, Ricky. He had a tremendous year last year, young Baddams, and he's only small, but he's got plenty of courage and very good with his skill level. Bickley, this bloke's a good player too, Bickley, in my opinion. Did it cleverly, a long kick up towards full forward. It goes, Woodlands is back there, so is Warhurst. Thumps away, straight to Cameron. Cameron with a long handball to his captain, Bennett, from centre half forward, this way, that way. Back onto the right boot, goes into the pocket and finds Brockhurst. Well, South Adelaide's play up forward, Rick, is excellent.
Yes, it certainly is. And Brockhurst, you can see in your screen there, he's standing, big Tommy Warhurst coming back, and he'd be wanting to impress tonight. And this would be the player that I wouldn't like to be on when I'm coming back to impress, Kim.
Yes, the former Fitzroy player, Andrew Brockhurst. Kick number 7. The goal umpire going to his left. Has it come back enough? No, it hasn't. It's offline. Only a minor score, so South go to 7-7. Kicking away from the legs, 3-2.
You look at South Adelaide's forward line tonight, and you mentioned a couple of seconds ago, Ken, they've got everybody. They've got Stokel at full forward, Brockhurst out there. They've got a number of players. Troy, well, we could go on. Woodlands, there's such a lot of players there getting kicks tonight.
The kick was very good from Sheldrick. Thomas dropped it, but he recovered to bring the ball back up towards Hall. There is Bennett over the top. He can't control the football, and we'll have a throw-in on the outer side. We've had just over 14 minutes of this second term, and the Panthers are doing it quite well.
And you can see there in your screen number 51, a player Bone, and I think that he's been named in the squad, the youth squad, for the Crows. And that's, well, it'd be interesting to see how he performs tonight.
It's a good call, Rick, as Baddams takes the football. He puts it out towards Paul Page. He kicks, and he kicks long, albeit a wobbly one. And Nord have the numbers, but the football is taken by Brockhurst. He's been a very good player. Nailey from between his legs. Good handle out towards Paul Page. South Adelaide running in numbers. The disposal was poor. It goes straight to Thomas. Let's see if the Red Legs can set something up as James puts the ball up high. Lachlan Bowman sets himself. So too Marty Dillon, who takes the mark.
And Whitford is down behind play. The trainer is called Chris Churchill, I believe. He doesn't look too good, Whitford. But a great mark by Dillon. And the umpires have held up play as the stretcher comes onto the ground. It's Whitford who has gone down. And let's hope that it's not too bad. But the trainer, immediately he saw Whitford call for the stretcher. So Michael Whitford, who's played superbly at centre-half back, Rick, and that'll be a body blow to South Adelaide.
Yes, it certainly would. And I didn't see it, as a matter of fact, Ken. But when you're looking at him there, he doesn't look too flash. And of course, coming off on a stretcher doesn't help.
15 and a half minutes into the second term, and it's South Adelaide 7-7-49, Norwood 3-2.
To Football Park as we see Michael Whitford leading the ground. Norwood 3-2, South Adelaide 7-7.
As he goes off the ground, it's bad luck because he's had five kicks, one handball and one mark, and I think he's been completely on top of Jonathan Ross at centre half back where he's been playing, and that's a shame for South Adelaide.
Well, Rick, Jonathan Ross is yet to get a possession. Randall Bone has now gone to centre half back. Heath back on the ground as a ruckman.
As Dillon goes towards centre half forward, a chance now for Norwood to work out of defence. Comes the way now of Zimmerman. Towards centre half forward he goes. A pack forms, thumped away by Bone. Good defensive work. Bone with a chance. It's a handball off to James. James with a good centering kick towards the centre half forward. Almost a mark to Michael Ace. Taken by Payne. Dummies back. Back towards Malloy. Malloy to McIntosh from the 50 metre line. Up towards full forward. South Adelaide. Too strong a defence. And a good mark has been taken here by Smith.
Well, Ken, when you're looking up forward for Norwood, they've only got Lachlan Bowman as far as over 6 foot. And they look pretty short up forward.
Yeah, 50 metre as a Norwood player encroached over the mark. So Stephen Smith will get a 50 metre penalty kick.
Ken, I'd be looking to give Michael Ace a run on the ball for the last 5 or 6 metres of this term. And likewise, if I was in charge of South Adelaide, it'd be a good time to bring Winton onto the ground.
Yeah, I agree with Michael Ace. I think he might give him a bit of bite around the packs, Kim. His body's going hard. Chance for Michael Bennett. Centre wing, around the body, he goes back towards half-forward, but it's all Norwood back here. Bam, got the mark he should have taken, but recovers well. Centre wing position up high, Jonathan Ross. And the ball forced out of...
And at 4:30 a.m. tomorrow morning, the Lipton's International Players Championship Tennis, live via satellite and Nine's Wide World of Sports.
And Kim, you've got young Jonathan Ross coming off the ground. I would have thought I would have given him a couple of more minutes just with Whitford going off. But you can just imagine now, with him coming off, his confidence would be down a bit.
It certainly would, but he's not finding the ball, Rick, so Neil Craig has to make changes as Naylor puts the handball out towards Page.
And look at this run by the South Adelaide defence. Over to Grummet. Grummet towards centre wing. A chance for Tanner. Kicked off the ground. Was good work towards Naylor. Payne. Smith does it cleverly. Long handball. Oh, has three or four loose players out there, South Adelaide. And finally, it's Page. Has a bounce. Centre wing out of sight. The Panthers into attack. A long kick by Page. All Norwood back there, and Barm will take the mark in defence. Barm at centre half back. We've played 18 minutes, almost 19 minutes into the second quarter. South 7-7, Norwood 3-2.
And Martin Pike has gone to centre half forward for Norwood. And Ivan Muster is onto the ground, and he's playing at full forward, and he is capable of kicking goals. As Tanner brings the ball to the outer side, looking for James, he was underneath it. Pike, the man I was just talking about, leads in the chase. He's pressured by Page. Over the top there is Mark Naylor, and he'll be happy as that ball goes over the line.
Don't forget, of course, tonight at a special time. Hey, hey, it's Saturday, 8:35 on 9.
We've had 19 and a half minutes of this second term. Marty Dillon grabbed the ball from the throw and gets the kick away. He gives 110%. This time he just pulls that ball over the line. And that goes out of bounds on the full. And that bench would be a little concerned. Neil Craig talking to Phil Gallagher as Binder had a good first term. Gets around the man on the mark with Concham at ease. Brings the ball in long. There's a big leap on the outer side. No one could take it. Thomas was in there and he was out just as quick. And once more we'll have a throw in.
Yes, well, I said a couple of minutes ago that Norwood are a little bit short up forward. They've got Lachlan Bohm, as we mentioned. But they just need, as far as I'm concerned, they just need someone up forward that can kick a couple of goals. And Neil Craig, of course, has gone for Muster.
Dillon handballs away. A chance now for Bickley. Has a bounce. Good shepherding by Dewhurst. Bickley at centre wing with a long handball. Finds Naylor. South Adelaide using the ball superbly. Look at that. Straight to Woodlands. Woodlands players running wild, South Adelaide players. Half forward, Frank Bickley's covered a tremendous amount of territory. Steckle, great stuff, South Adelaide. That was superb work, Jumbo.
Well, you can't do any better than that, Ken. Coming from the back lines, right down the outer side wing, and a beautiful placement by Bickley. Really, he got hold of the football from centre half back. He didn't stop, he waited, and then shot down the outer side, took the ball again from Woodlands, and given Stokel a chance.
Chance to kick his fourth. Not an easy shot, this one. The goal umpire hasn't moved. Goal number four to David Steckle.
He's a magnificent player when he's in a bit of form. And I think you'll find a little bit of confidence. He can mark the ball from anywhere. Number 33 in your screen. And if he gets a little bit of confidence, he can kick the ball through the eye of a needle. Bickley, great little player coming down from Port Pirie. Didn't just blaze away. And there wasn't anything Sheldrick could do about that.
Kim, would you put Tommy Warhurst on...
on Steckel?
No question, Ken. We mentioned earlier about the form of Brad Sheldrick. He has been a good player, but he's a youngster. He's getting beaten at the moment. He's had four goals kicked on him by Steckel, and Warhurst is the man, and he should go back there as soon as possible, in our humble opinion, as Troy tried to crash his way through. Stolen by Payne. The Redlegs need a reply, and they need it quickly. The ball is put in, an ace. Two against one. He's being outnumbered, and... I really feel he should be given a bit of space and a quick run on the ball as Randall Bone puts the ball in. Heath couldn't take it. Bennett at the back of the pack. They've had numbers to the fall of the ball. That's been the secret to their success, South Adelaide, as Woodland skirts the outer, the grandstand boundary line. The kick wasn't well dispatched and the mark's been taken by Warren Halfpenny. He's had seven kicks and he puts this one up high. Oh, big leap there by Schmid. Couldn't take it. Offhand's Payne. The feed is good. Zimmerman puts the ball forward. Back there is Dillon, close to the boundary line. The handball is good to Battams. That one is better to find Kapler. It pushes out a pass with the left boot, and he's found Woodlands, another left footer. Naily it is. He should get it in quickly. He plays on those little legs, pumping like pistons. Well, it was touched off the boot. Play on the call. Snared there by Cameron. Couldn't get the handball away. In there is Bennett. Great desperation. The handball went to Smart. He's been very quiet. This man, Cameron, hasn't been. His handball goes back towards Bennett once more. Smothered. Binder in there. So too Zimmerman. Binder. The boundary line will win out.
Yeah, well, no one knew really where the boundary line was there on your screen. We thought the 50-metre line was the boundary. But Norwood under pressure a little bit here. South Adelaide just going ahead.
Well, South Adelaide's use of the football is superb. Towards Battams. Good body work on that occasion by Naylor, and the ball is forced out of play again.
Mate, you can see why Naylor's such an important player. You can see why Carlton wanted him for so many years. He just gets where the ball is and just does something with it.
Smart. And Warhurst. Warhurst with the tap taken by Naylor. Over towards Bickley. Bickley up towards centre-half. Test of courage there as Woodlands has the football. Kicks towards goal. It's offline, way offline, and in fact out of bounds on the full.
Well, very impressed there by number 16 in your screen, Craig Woodlands. That was a super bit of work. He ran just smack back right into the pack and should have finished it off with a goal.
A kick back towards the half-back flank for Norwood. Thumped away by a Hall. Tanner works hard. Out it comes. Chance now for David Payne to do something with the footy. Has a bounce. He'll be run down, will he? No. Gets the kick in the nick of time towards half-forward. Off-hands it goes. To Lachlan Bowman to Mello. That's good work by Nort. A chance for the legs. Back towards Mello. Into the pocket. Kicks towards goal. He's next.
Great thing about Norwood and the great thing about Neil Craig, he wouldn't be worried. He'd be a little bit probably upset. Away, I suppose the word is concerned because they're four or five goals down. But the young players are getting hold of the football, but they just can't finish it off.
Well, that was tremendous pressure by South Adelaide. That's why Norwood didn't kick a goal in. As the ball comes to ground, it's picked up by Battams. Left foot, round his body. Back there is Zimmerman. The ball's still in play. A suicidal approach, and it may pay off. Well done, Malloy, but it was set up through the courage of Zimmerman. Now Malloy puts the ball forward. It's a wobbly kick, though, taken by Paul Page. Gets the handball out towards Dewhurst and Battams, but the ball is taken over the line. And we are into time on. We've had nearly 25 minutes of this second term. And it's 21 points Norwood, South Adelaide 55 points. Great game of football on Nine's Wide World of Sports. Dillon couldn't take it. In there getting the kick away is Pike, one of his few for the night. But the mark is taken by Bone. In fact, that was Pike's first kick. Randall Bone drops in a short pass. He finds McGregor Grummett. He in turn goes short as the siren sounds. And it is South Adelaide leading by 34 points.
South Adelaide continue on their merry way in that quarter, going further and further ahead. They had players all over the ground, all up forward, and really put the nail in the coffin, you might say, at half-time.
And at the big break, it is South Adelaide, 8-7-55, Norwood 3-3-21. You're watching this Foundation Cup Grand Final live on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Up
the long break, it's all South Adelaide at quarter time. South Adelaide in front by 3 points, 2-5 to 2-2. But at half time, a great second quarter by the Panthers, 8-7 for Norwood, 3-3.
Looking at the goal kickers, Lachlan Bowman has kicked 3 for Norwood. And for South Adelaide, Steckel 4, Cameron 2, Brockhurst and Troy 1 apiece.
And Kim, South Adelaide clearly the better side in that second quarter. They took control. Their small men were magnificent and the use of the ball was superb.
Yes, well, you talk of their small men. Cameron and Ailey have been very good.
Troy.
And Darren Troy has been beating Gary McIntosh. But they've also stronger up four. But more importantly, they're running in numbers.
Yep.
And they've got players at the fall of the ball. And that's been the difference because they have more options when someone does take possession.
Well, Norwood will certainly come back strongly, hopefully, in the second half. But going to the earlier game tonight, a good victory to Port Adelaide over the Tigers by 11 points. And there you see it. At quarter time, the Tigers led 4-2 to 3-1. Half time, Port Adelaide in front, 9-4 to 5-4. And at three-quarter time, it was the Tigers by 7 points. But at the final game, Port Adelaide too good, 48-92 to 12-9-81.
And the goal kickers for Port Adelaide, Tyler kicked 4, McKay and Williams 2 apiece. And for Glenelg, Russell 3, Jamison 3 and Brett Dean kicked 2.
And after the game, of course, David McKay spoke to the captain of Port Adelaide.
Winning consolation final, Captain Greg Phillips. Greg, it was a win, but it wasn't an easy one.
Oh, for sure it wasn't easy. We got a few problems last week. North Adelaide came and nearly rolled us, and in our third quarter again this week wasn't that good. And, but our first half was good, and, and the last quarter was good. So I suppose, we've got something to look forward to, first one-round game next week. So really just got to work on that and make sure our third and final quarters we give a little bit more.
The problem didn't seem to be whether you got the ball, it was the way you used it. I was just having a chat with John Cale. He was bitterly disappointed with the way you delivered the ball, particularly into the forward zone.
Yeah, I think our vision wasn't there today. Blokes didn't lift up the head, and you were right there. At times we did kick the ball, had possession of the ball, and we give it straight back to Glenelg. And, that's something we've got to practice on.
One player I thought that was particularly impressive was the former Western Australian player, Gary Smaldridge.
Yes.
He seems to have fitted in pretty well.
He slotted in well, and last week was his first whole week that he's been training with us. And he's going to be a real asset to us. He's a real nuggety bloke, bores in, gets the ball, and he's one of the players who can hit blokes on the chest with his pass. Very good pass of the ball.
It's very rare that a player comes from anywhere and claims the centre at Port Adelaide.
Yes, he's got something to live up to there, but he's going to be a good player.
Steve Williams doesn't seem to be in great form. Perhaps the move out of centre hasn't helped his game.
No, I think he was carrying a little bit of an injury today. Jack had asked him half-time to come off, and he said he'd try, keep running out the third quarter, but I think his legs started to tighten up a bit. So, in the Foundation Cup, you can run an extra few reserves, so it's a good thing to give the blokes a run and, use your reserves.
And how did you rate the form of Wes Fellows, the former Collingwood player? He played tonight, and he's not a certain Port Adelaide player yet.
No, he's not a certain player. I was with Wes all this morning, and he was pretty keen to do well. And
Not at the pub.
not at the pub. There's a bit of pressure on the lad to come over. Not no one. I introduced him to all the boys, and I thought he'd done pretty well. Since you're pretty new to the club, and you're asking a fair bit of a player to sort of step straight into a club, and expect to know each other's voices and to tap the ball down to him. And he'd done a few useful things, and for the amount of time he's been here.
Since Russell Johnson left to go to Millicent in the southeast, you really have looked like you might have been thin on ruckman. But I thought Brett Chalmers' form today wasn't too bad, and you've got another couple of young ruckmen in the reserves that certainly might make the grade.
Yeah, well, it's going to be interesting to see if Wes does come here. But if he doesn't come over here, well, we'll have to Grimmy and Brett
Shane
Chalmers,
Grimm.
Shane Grimm and Brett Chalmers to have a go at it. And Brett done well, like you said today, and he's learning week by week, and he's going to be a good player.
Three flags in a row. Can you win another one?
Oh, too right. That's our aim. And, next week's a real one. And, we've got to start off with a win.
Good luck.
Yeah, thank you very much.
David McKay there talking to Greg Phillips. And I thought Delaney came back to some scintillating form tonight, Kim, for Port Adelaide.
Well, he's a good player, and we always knew that. His first game when he came back, he had 6 goals kicked on him by Michael Dittmar. But that's not a true indication of his ability, and that's taking nothing away from Dittmar. But he did play well tonight, and he combined well with George Fiarchi.
What about Wes Fellows? How do you see his performance?
I think he'll be a huge asset if he does decide to stay here in South Australia. And also, Port Adelaide picking up the $8,000,
yep.
If they do decide to pursue the services of Fellows, that will come in more than handy.
And the Magpies getting 8 and Glenelg getting 6,000.
6,000 for the Tigers, it's not bad money for a game of football.
Great night's work. Okay, we'll come back with more footy right after the break. Stay with us. welcome back to Football Park. There you saw some magnificent highlights throughout the Foundation Cup, and I guess the highlight was that superb mark by young Jonathan Rosrick.
Yes, I've been waiting for it tonight, Ken, but you can't take those sort of marks when you're sitting in the bunker, can you?
No, you can't, but there have been some marvellous moments in the game tonight, particularly by South Adelaide. As I said to Ken, they're used to the ball, and they really impressed me. They've got tall timber, got the small quick men. They are a very good side, Rick.
Yes, they certainly are. They seem to have a pitcher up forward too, Ken.
Yeah, they do.
They're not just blasting the ball away. They're using Stokel up forward, Stickle up forward. God, I'll get it right one of these days. They're using him up forward, and of course Smart hasn't done a lot tonight, Ken, but they're looking very, very good up forward.
Yeah, Sticker there kicking a goal, and he's kicked four goals, and he certainly has played superbly. Mr. 1-10's on the boundary line. Graham, of course, would you agree with our comments that South Adelaide look a very good side?
Yes, Ken, there's no question. They're a very accomplished side all of a sudden. They're playing with an authority they haven't shown for years, Ken, quite frankly. And the big thing is, I think Rick might have touched on it, or if Rick didn't, Kim did, numbers at the ball.
Yes.
There's an old theory in football, if you have numbers at the ball, you'll win more games than you'll lose. Every time there's a loose ball, there's two South Adelaide people to one Norwood player, or conversely, 3-2, or 4-3. Every time they outnumber the opposition, and that's spelling doom for Norwood so far.
And Graham, of course, a valuable player coming back from Fitzroy for the Panthers is Andrew Brockhurst.
Yes, Ken, there was a query on Andrew Brockhurst from where I sat as a so-called expert. His kicking for goal wasn't the best thing in the world he had to offer. In fact, his kicking in general play wasn't strong, but he's kicked well tonight. I've had a very critical eye on Andrew Brockhurst most of the night. He kicked a nice goal, as probably was on your screen just then, and earlier he was kicking with some authority in his field disposal.
And I guess, Graham, we were rather critical of young Cameron, the former Geelong player, when he first played for South, but his form tonight's been outstanding.
Well, Ken, all of a sudden, he's part of the team. I think he felt strange, like most players do. Martin Ailey's feeling a bit strange, I believe, tonight, on occasions, you know. It's hard to fit into a different pattern of play, perhaps, and young Cameron certainly was all at sea the first two or three games, but tonight, he's out there like a seasoned performer and doing very well.
And, Graham, for Norwood, of course, Lachlan Bowman's their only real shining light up forward.
Well, Kim, it's a one-man band up there, really. Take away Bowman's three goals, one. They've scored 2 points for the night. So he certainly has been a shining light in their forward line and is a player of the future also. But other players have got to join in. People like David Payne particularly. He's got to straighten out his kicking foot. He's had a couple of shots for goal, but blasted away. And really, those two kicks he had early in the piece should have been goals.
Graham, talking about David Stickle, we made mention during the call that perhaps it may have been wise to move Tommy Warhurst on the Stickle. Would you have done that?
Yep, no question, Ken. Tom Warhurst really is like a fish out of water, playing in the permanent back pocket slot. And he needs to play at full back. I think that Neil Craig is showing confidence in young Sheldrick. And he's done a couple of nice things. But in theory, Warhurst should be playing full back, yes.
Well, Graham, just once again, how did you pick to win tonight's game?
I'm glad you asked, Ken. I haven't been very right this year. I said South 1-10. Can I change that? South 21-30.
That's Graham Cameron on the boundary line.
He's good, isn't he?
And certainly it's worth playing for, not the prize money so far as the Foundation Cup is concerned. $17,000. Rick, that's good money. And also $10,000 for the runner-up. We'll come back with more footy right after the break. Stay here. Park. It's in the grand final of the Foundation Cup between Norwood and South. And Ricky, you've got some interesting stats there.
Yeah, certainly have. The stats really show South Adelaide. 90 kicks, Ken, 66 handballs to Norwood, 70 kicks and 44. So really, South Adelaide are doing not only getting more of the ball, but they're using it more up forward.
And also, Graham Campbell talking about the square. Norwood are winning the rucks, but South Adelaide have taken the ball out of the square a lot more times.
Well, they have, Ken. There's no question about that. I think that the alertness of the South Ravers, I suppose Martin Ailey to a certain degree, but to Gary Cameron certainly, and Darren Troy's impact in the centre, Ken, has been non-plussing the opposition. It really has. John Hall is a hurtful sort of a ruck, but he runs straight at the opposition, and he can really put the fear of God into the opposition from time to time, but it's not really working tonight what John is trying, and okay, he might be winning the knockout, but it's going to the opposition more times than not, or the South Adelaide people.
Graham, what about Mark Naley? He's back from Carlton. Tonight he's really showing something.
Well, I think he can do better than that though, Rick, even though you say he's showing something. I think he hasn't got away from his opponent as well as he could have, and one time down in the far left-hand pocket in the first quarter, he actually lost the ball without really gaining possession of it. And uncharacteristic of Naley. He can do better, but yes, he's improving.
Good on your ground, Mr. 1-10 on the boundary line at half-time. It's the Panthers by 34 points. The start of the third quarter is about to happen. Here's Kim Dillon.
Thanks very much, Ken, Rick and Graham. Umpire Richard Williams with the football. The second half is about to commence. 3-3 opposed to 8-7. This will be make or break time for the Red Legs. They trail by 34 points, as Ken mentioned. And onto the ground, it appears, is Michael Thompson for Norwood into the ruck. He is wearing Guernsey number 30, a most promising junior player, and he wins the first tap down towards McIntosh. He tried to check side that ball back, but it goes straight towards Matthew Baddams. So the smaller running brigade for South Adelaide have been far superior this evening as Baddams puts the ball forward. The fist away from behind came from Barm, read beautifully off hands by Woodlands. He steadies, goes towards goal. That is a magnificent start to the Panthers.
Well, you've got to have a little bit of luck in football, and it seems to be going South Adelaide's way tonight. Number 16 in your screen, South Adelaide players, they're ecstatic. They started brilliantly in that second quarter, straight after the first quarter. And here in the third quarter, they've come out and they've kicked a goal in the first couple of seconds. So they're going right on with the job. They seem to have players all over the ground. They seem to have forwards kicking goals. And what more could you ask for?
Exactly, Rick. And I'll tell you what, that man in your screen, Woodlands, after having a couple of horrific knee injuries, is back to his brilliant best. And he'll be a real bonus for South Adelaide. Ball thumped away by Heath. Back towards McIntosh. Cameron, tremendous first half. Handball off was looking on this occasion for Bickley. Over the top, Zimmerman now with an opportunity, taps it out. Ace appears to be on the ball now in this third quarter as he gets it out to Halfpenny. Back towards the half-forward flank it goes, and a good mark has been taken out there by Zeeland. Former Sturt player, half-forward right. Norwood into attack towards the lake end. That's the left of your screen, but it's all South Adelaide back there, and Stephen Smith takes a fine mark in defence.
He's played pretty well. He hasn't had a lot to do tonight, but... He's very solid back there in defence.
And he'd be pleased about that, Rick. His teammates down the ground doing a tremendous job as Baddam sockers that ball off the ground. And the ball goes out of play, but he gained his side about 10 or 15 metres.
Well, we mentioned that just before the half-time break, Aisha's got to be on the ball, and he's immediately gone in there. So Norwood bringing on Andrew Zeeland to centre-half forward, it looks like. So they've made a couple of changes.
Michael Aisha's only had three possessions for the game out of that forward pocket. He has been starved of opportunities as Zeeland takes the ball out of the pack, out towards Thomas. He's been a quiet player, wobbles one forward. The mark has been taken by McGregor Grump. Number 25 for the Panthers. Been a handy pickup. His debut season was last year. That is kick number 5. To the outer side, and the mark is taken by Randall Bone. Promising youngster, kick number 6, puts it up towards the outer wing. Players set themselves. Sheldrick punches the ball away. Sheldrick may have been moved away from Steckel. That's not a bad move. In fact, it's a good move and a rather obvious one as Bennett gets the handle out to Troy. He's been a good player. Out to Brockhurst. Likewise, the ball in turn looking for Woodland. Strong mark.
Well, he certainly looks the goods up forward. I know I've said it a couple of times, but you need a forward that roams around and kicks goals. And South Adelaide coming from the bays, he has really certainly done that tonight.
This will be his 9th kick. He's kicked 1 goal. He's normally quite accurate. Uses the right leg. He starts it to the right-hand side of the goalpost, and it stayed in that position. It's over the line for a point.
Tommy Warhurst has been moved on to Steckel. That's the move we suggested in the second quarter might happen. So the two moves that we suggested have happened. Ace on the ball and Tommy Warhurst to full back. The game's easy from the grandstand, I can tell you. Heath almost the mark. Gains possession. A wobbly kick towards centre-half forward. Over the top, Woodlands. The mark has not been paid. Sheldrick there. Working hard was Binder. In towards Thompson. Also the mark not played on that occasion. Finally it comes out to Halfpenny. Halfpenny towards centre wing. Dillon. Tremendous game in the first half, Dillon. Plenty of courage about this young man. Over to Troy, who also played well for the Panthers. Towards half-forward. But here we see Barm chipping in for the legs. Back towards the half-forward flank it goes. Payne is under the football. Doesn't take the mark, but gains possession. Over to Zeeland. Outside the 50. Up towards the forward pocket it goes. Off hands. Chance for South Adelaide. Will that be a free kick to Smith? Not paid. Murdoch. Froggy Murdoch in towards full forward. Towards the goals. Across the face of goals. And a good mark. Been taken by Bone. That's a strong mark.
He's shaping up to be a pretty good player. We mentioned that he got on the youth list for the Crows, and every time he gets near the football, he was, KG just said, he does get it, and he does something with it when he does get it.
Kapler likewise, as he drives the ball long. The ball just touched before going out of play. We've had just over 4 minutes of this third term. Norwood 3-3, South Adelaide 9-8. You're live on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
And Kim, I've noticed tonight that every time the South Adelaide, they handball the ball on, and then immediately they've handballed the ball, they go to shepherd the player running through.
Yes, their teamwork has been exemplary. As that ball goes towards the boundary line once more, it's just in play. Kapler there and quite happy to take it over the line. Now, Malloy's been a quiet player tonight. He's been no lone ranger in that regard. And let's not forget, coming up tonight at 8.30, Super 66 and Saturday Cross Lotto draws at 8.33, National 9 News break, followed by Hey Hey, It's Saturday with Daryl Summers, and that is a fantastic show. Richard Williams blows the whistle. McIntosh, who just extracted himself from the pack.
I reckon Mac has gone back to his old style of last year, trying to intimidate too much, Kim, rather than get the footy as he's been doing in the Foundation Cup games.
Yes, he's had a very good Foundation Cup series, but perhaps Macca, who normally intimidates players, is being intimidated by the good work of his opponent in Darren Troy. And you always look a bit ordinary, Ken, when you're chasing the jumper, and that's what's happening with Nord at the moment as Binder puts the ball up towards centre half forward. Oh, there he is again. Randall Bone is very impressive, Rick.
Very, very impressive, and he's playing across that half back line, eyes on the football, and one grab the ball.
It's his fourth big mark as Dylan comes away with a footy towards the centre of the ground. Woodland's out there, striking. I think he is everywhere. He is giving Zimmerman a run around. Kick number 10. It's not a good one. It doesn't find the mark. Dewhurst is the player he was looking for. Thought about the handball, then decides to go long towards half forward. Over the top, Barmer's the spoiler. Brockhurst almost should have, and the ball's gone out of play.
Even South Adelaide, Ken, they're starting to. They know full well that Craig Barm's going to knock the ball forward, and on that occasion three or four players, Brockhurst in particular, stood down in front thinking, well, this is where the ball's going to be.
Smart. Nailey, beautifully done by Bickley, up toward full forward. Warhurst, Steckle. Steckle used the body. A chance now for Woodlands. Handball's back. Dewhurst smothered by Zimmerman. In goes Woodlands. Down goes Woodlands. That was a heavy one. Binder tries to crash through, and in fact has been given a free kick for hanging on, but Woodlands copped the high one.
He certainly did. Isn't it interesting to have Smart up forward? I've known him as a very, very good back player, and he hasn't done a lot up forward tonight.
Nothing, Rick, I would say. He's been extremely quiet. He's had five possessions all up in just over 2.5 quarters of football. Craig Binder kicked the ball in, and the ball is now with Lachlan Bowman, and he, in fact, is the leading goal scorer for Norwood because he is the only goal scorer. Kick number 7. He's kicked 3 for the night. Over the top, Zealand puts the hand up, and that's holding the ball. Let's see if they can capitalise from this opportunity. Andrew Zealand, affable young man, drives the ball in. Former Sturt player, it's a nice-looking kick. Up high was Muster, couldn't take it. Murdoch there, playing out of a forward pocket. Back to Payne, he's kicked 2 points. He won't get a goal this time, he won't even get the distance. Schmid over towards Dewhurst. Oh, South Adelaide, they're a very good football side in 1991. Thanks very much, Panthers.
Well, that's incredible. You give them a rap and they let you down. And on that occasion, they looked like they were going to move the ball out quickly. But I think it was McGrummett's big handball went over the top of Paul Page.
Well, you can forgive anyone a mistake, but they are a good side. And they won't be just March champions. They'll continue this form right throughout 1991 as Aish centres the ball nicely. Muster back there, but the ball goes over the line for a point. We are live on Nine's Wide World of Sports here at Football Park. Conditions are magnificent. A crowd of around 10,000 people, and this is the 1991 Foundation Cup final.
And are we seeing, Kim, that the final last year, South Adelaide haven't beaten Norwood for years and years and years, and this will be a couple of, if they can get up tonight, it'll be a couple of times, and that bit of confidence could go through, and I've known it to go through for a couple of years.
Well, Ricky, South knocked off Norwood by 42 points in last year's elimination final, but I agree with you, they haven't had many days of glory against the Redlands.
Ace tries to work the ball away. Malloy taken by Kapler. Kapler with a long kick back towards centre wing, thumped away by Sheldrick. Thomas, chance for McIntosh. Dewhurst didn't shirk the issue. In goes Binder. Some heavy bodywork in that passage of play. Troy goes down. Plenty of courage there. Also Macca, Bickley, like his game night been tremendous. Nailey goes short. He'll find his captain Bennett at centre wing grandstand side. Some desperation by both sides in that passage of play. Bennett, good entertaining game of football towards half forward. Bam, bumped it away, half penny, dispossessed. In goes Smart, stolen by Payne, over to Thomas, back to McIntosh. McIntosh looks for options, goes the way of Tanner. Fine young player towards Thompson. This kid's got some promise too. Onto the left boot, towards half forward he goes.
on a strong mark in defence has been taken on that occasion by Grummet, I think it is.
They certainly have got the towering strength down there. And this fellow, we've mentioned a couple of times, coming from Hawthorne in his second year, and he really looks the goods, whether he's at centre-half forward or centre-half back.
Yeah, good comment, Jim. That's his go. He's very versatile. His halfpenny takes a good mark. Into attack they go, Nord. Off hands to Binder. Back towards Keith Thomas. He can't pick up the football. Does it the second attempt, but gee whiz, strong work by Smith. Kept the ball, or smothered the ball. Players working to get it out. Scrambly stuff at the moment. Troy is there. McIntosh. Not pretty football. Taken on this occasion by Bennett. Over towards Baddams. Towards half forward. Brockhurst. Sheldrick with him. Does it well. Young Sheldrick on that occasion. Finally it's stolen on this occasion by Bickley. Back towards Baddams. Baddams with the ball towards the band line. Stays in play. No, it doesn't. Out of play.
Brockhurst looking very good up forward. South Adelaide players all over the ground trying to get into that front spot. Troy, Bennett, they've got a number of players that are winning their position and they're quite rightly in front.
Darryl Heath wins the tap, but Froggy Murdoch wins the football. He puts it up high. Players set themselves. A little bit of indecision there by most of the players surrounding that football, but the handball goes out to Dillon. The ball was smothered off the boot. In there is Bennett, the captain. Payne tries to get the ball out to Thomas. Too slow. Oh, Naylor, he's quick, but Thomas has the football. Back to Zealand. The handball over the top to Bowman. Can he kick number four right on the 50-metre line? He drives it in. And it's only a minor score. Through for a point. Norwood 3-5, trailing a determined South Adelaide, 9-8.
Well, Norwood are going to have to do something. I see Jonathan Roth is back on the ground. Michael Ash has had a run on the ball. So I think you'll find that Craig is using all of his options.
Thompson, they're not coming off, Jumbo, as Kimbo said in my right ear. Taken by McIntosh through the 50, a long kick up towards Fulford. Sadly, just offline. That's the one they needed. It may have been the one to have lift the red legs.
Well, you'll be starting to chew the old Chewy a bit harder, and you mentioned a couple of minutes ago that he's gone back to his old ways. Well, that's the McIntosh that Norwood need. Get hold of the football, burst through the pack, and get it into that forward line.
Kick in. Jonathan Ross, who was taken from the ground in the second quarter. The Payne, the Thomas. Now, can he drill this one? Keith Thomas is coming back. That one's home. Good goal to Norwood.
Well, I suppose you're going to have to say it's about time, because if Norwood are going to get up in this game, that's the type of play that Norwood are going to have to play. We've seen them play it before. I saw them 6 goals down a couple of weeks ago. Beautiful hand pass over by Payne. And Thomas, a veteran, started with Norwood, went over to Melbourne. Fitzroy came back. And if the players are going to perform, he's one of the ones that are going to have to finish the play off.
The Red Legs hanging in there just 4-6, South Adelaide 9-8. We're in the grand final of the Foundation Cup. Thomas again, or pushed in the back, and that's what the free kick is for. Play on advantage, steadying is Zealand, and that is two quick goals, and the game is alive again.
Well, Norwood, we mentioned a couple of minutes ago in the crowd, half asleep. I thought if you're a Norwood supporter about a quarter of an hour ago, Andrew Zealand's come on to centre-half forward. Should have been a mark. The umpire, I think, would have paid it, played on, and Andrew Zealand swooped on the football, could see that Norwood needing goals, steadied himself, no South Adelaide player within a bull's roar, and he's brought up a couple of goals in a couple of minutes.
26 points of difference, with South Adelaide in front. A couple of South Adelaide players weren't happy about that. The kick being paid to advantage, as we see South 9-8, Norwood 5-6. 13 and a half minutes into the third quarter. What a good game of football. That's got to be a free kick, not seen by the umpire. Sheldrick wins the footy, goes over the top to Payne. He's dispossessed. Murdoch in there, works hard, gets a handball out. Comes the way of Dewhurst. With him is Tanner. Tanner did that very well, young Grant Tanner. Back to McIntosh. There appears to be more urgency in the game by Norwood at the moment. McIntosh goes out wide, looking for Zealand. Oh, good mark to the youngster by picking a big right peach. Zealand now with a chance. Oh, it's a high one. Get under that one if you're game. Up goes the pack. Ball to ground. Ace is there. Stolen by Cameron. Cameron out wide to Page. The Panthers running the ball out of defence. A chance for Troy. Picks up the footy. Goes towards centre wing. Now watch this young man go. Baddams. Centre wing out of side. He'll put the Panthers into attack. Into the pocket he goes. Brockhurst. Beautifully put. And a strong mark. Very good footy we're seeing here on Nine's Wide World of Sports. Live at headquarters. Andrew Brockhurst. Presley back from Fitzroy towards full forward. It goes. Barham behind.
Peter puts Bone in the back over the top. Wallen's into an open goal, and that's the breather for the Panthers.
Well, good work by Norwood early. Andrew Zealand coming on at centre half forwards, I think, has brought Norwood a light. But unfortunately, they got up, South Adelaide got the ball out, and over the top of the pack came Craig Balm. Really had no eyes for the football. I think he just wanted to knock the pack down. The ball came over the top of the pack. Number 16 in your screen. Woodland swooped on the football and brought up their 10.
South Adelaide steadied the ship a little there on 10-8. Norwood 5-6, and the Red Leagues paying for the cardinal sin of not having a man at the back of the pack, allowing Woodlands to kick his second goal. And John Reid has made a move. The Buffalo, the Bull, Geoffrey Winton onto the ground. And this is a good tactical move.
Yes, it certainly is. They need a couple of goals. And Mac and Big Macca there just gave him a bit of a nudge just to let him know that he's around.
He would not like to be in between those two players as Marty Dillon picks up the football, puts it out towards the boundary line, picked up brilliantly by Zimmerman. He brings the ball back. Underneath it is Bowman. Couldn't take it. Zealand. Well, he's having an influence on the game in this third term. He's had 8 possessions and Murdoch's had 5, so they've been good. Oh, Ace should have held it. Taken by Tanner. Michael Ace having a very quiet night. This will be the second goal for Zealand, and he's kicked it.
Well, the difference between the sides. There he is in your screen, Andrew Zealand. I've seen him perform at centre-half back and centre-half forward. Look at the old timer there, Michael Ace. He would have swallowed that a couple of years ago, and it went over to Andrew Zealand, and he's been very, very prominent early in this third quarter, and I suppose Neil Craig should have brought him on earlier.
South Adelaide 10-8, Norwood 6-6, and we're 16 and a half minutes into the third quarter. Taken by Murdoch, set upon by Cameron. And certainly Rick Zealand has had a big influence on this game in the third quarter for Norwood.
He certainly has, and you can see Whitford, the old centre-half back, and Smart, who's been doing a fair bit of work, or he's played up until now on the half-forward line, has gone back on Andrew Zealand.
Dewhurst in there, tackled by Tanner. Players trying to work the football out, but umpire Laurie Argent has the last say, and he'll have a bounce.
And Ken John Reid quick to recognise the impact that Andrew Zealand is having at centre-half forward. And as Rick mentioned, Smart has gone back there. Zealand has had 9 possessions in this third term, and Murdoch, playing out of the forward pocket, has had 5.
Umpires are Laurie Argent and Richard Williams, taken by McIntosh, who's had an influence on the game in this third quarter. Challenge for Smart, favoured by a good bounce. Has the football on the defensive side of centre. Toward half-forward he goes, looking for his captain and Bennett. Humped away from that player, out of play by Binder.
And I like Smart at centre-half back. I think he likes the ball coming down to him. He just can't seem to find the ball when he's got a play as a forward. And I think you'll see a different Smart in this quarter.
Balm off and Pike is on for Norwood. Taken by Cameron. Very good first half. Cameron up towards full forward. Werhurst. Steckel almost. Sheldrick. Steckel in there working hard. Players trying to get it out. But umpire Argent once again will call for a bounce with the ball. Almost in the square for the Panthers. Brockhurst in the bottom of the pack there. A very good night. Pushing and shoving. And a love lost out there at the moment. It's a grand final. Murdoch and Payne hurries it through for a minor score.
Look at the ball there a couple of minutes ago. He likes to be on that side. And if the ball had a lobbed in his arms, he would have certainly brought up another goal.
Tom Werhurst brings the ball back to the members' stand. Underneath it there is Halfpenny. Couldn't take it. Pushing it forward is Naley, like a terrier dog. He's in there. So too Murdoch. So Froggy Murdoch having a run on the ball, possibly as a rover. Picked up by Troy. He's dispatched over the boundary line. So too the football. Free kick to Grant Tanner.
A little bit more urgency from Norwood tonight. They seem to be catching South Adelaide. South Adelaide have been sort of taking a little bit of time, and that was just typical of Norwood in the last couple of minutes.
Red well at the back of the pack by Bennett. The handball goes back towards Kapler. He lifts the eyes, looks downfield, kick number 10, and he finds Winton, who picks up his first possession. Pike lets him go. Play on the call. McIntosh in there, stops in the nick of the time. I tell you, he plays to the crowd a bit, Macca, I reckon. Taken by Baddams, tried to get it back to Woodlands, close to the boundary line, still has the football. Good hand pass to Steckel. Very quick kick, and also it may be a brilliant kick. Oh, he kicked it. He kicked 4.
We'll make it 5 goals, and you wouldn't see a better goal anywhere than that.
Beautiful work there by Woodlands. And look at Stokel, Stickle, number 33 in your screen. Kicked the beautiful play. Woodlands has really surprised me tonight. He's got near the football. He can really take a mark. He's an opportunist. And Stickle just slammed the ball onto his foot and brought up a great goal.
Well, the excitement's got Kimbo. In fact, that was Steckle's fifth goal. The South lead 11-9-6-6, and we've played almost 20 minutes into the third quarter. Super game of football. Vickie, a great handball to Troy. Troy to the pocket, looking for the ball. He's found it. That's Winton, inside the 50. He's a big, strong man, Winton, the pinch hitter. Now he'll kick from outside the 50. He's going to give it a big ride, I tell you he will. Into the square to land. Woodlands has the sit, thumped away by Warhurst. Tanner went without the footy. Taken by Jennifer Wolf. She whiz, it just grazed the post and only a point.
Isn't it amazing, the Bull, Winton? He's got to possibly kick six goals to keep his spot. I've seen him do some amazing things, and next week he's back on the boundary.
He loves the bench. Kick-off has been marked by Craig Dewhurst. Goes short, looking for Steckle, and he's found. Good pass, good lead.
Ken, the difference is Steckle with a bit of confidence. He's completely a different player. He's leading and he's taking the ball. Although South Adelaide are playing the ball to him out in front, but he really looks a full forward.
He's had five kicks so far for five goals. He's had six kicks. That won't be a goal. So he's kicked 5-1. Certainly a very good night by Steckle. Ladies enjoying the... Or a lady, should I say, enjoying the footy. And so is that man, John Reid. Bobby Smith, the man with his fingers to his mouth. Certainly been a good performance by the Panthers as the kickoff comes back towards the grandstand side. Thompson almost the mark, a chance for Naley. Trapped it well. Pickley, Dewhurst inside the 50. It'll go into the square, but back there is Zimmerman.
Took the mark casually, now takes the ball to the outer side looking for Mello. Had a great first turn, but Baddams has been on top then, and since then, I should say. And that's been a good duel, that has. Let's not forget, at 4:30 a.m. tomorrow morning, the Lipton's International Players Championship Tennis, live via satellite on Nine's Wide World of Sport. In there is Bennett, so too Sheldrick. And Steck will kick the first four goals on that player as he gets the handball out towards Pike. Now the two number fives, quite an interesting situation out here. The two number fives, that's good play by Tanner. Two number fives playing on one wing, two number 11s on the other. And this contest is pretty even, Rick.
Yes, it certainly is. And I think you'll find Grant Tanner has been a real live wire other weeks. Dewhurst has just kept on the right side of him and just made it harder for him to get hold of the footy.
As I mentioned earlier, Mello on top in the first turn for Norwood, but Baddams in the second and in the third as Jonathan Ross gets his second touch for the night. To handball out towards Murdoch. The kick is a very good one to eight. This is possession number four or five. He hasn't had many. Puts it up high. Mooster up. Couldn't take it. Smart and... He does look a better player in defence. The handball is a sweeping and searching one out wide to find Baddams, the player we were talking about before. Matthew Baddams drops it in short. He finds Kapler. And South Adelaide just steadying the ship here. Kick number 11. 23 minutes into the third term. The ball put to the outer side. Steckle is the target as the siren sounds. And it sees South Adelaide with a 35-point advantage.
Yes, well, the Redlegs certainly did a better job in that quarter, but South Adelaide, when the pressure was right on them, stuck to their task, pushed the ball forward, and with the big fella Steckle at full forward, kicking six, they have got kept and kept their nose in front.
Yes, they certainly have. Steckle there on your screen. He's had a good night tonight. He's kicked 5-1. And full forward, you can't ask much more than that. The man on his right, Cameron, has also had a pretty good night. So at three-quarter time, it's the Panthers, 11-11. Leading Norwood 6-6. You're watching the Grand Final of the Foundation Cup live on Nine's Wide World of Sports.
At three-quarter time in the Grand Final of the Foundation Cup, quarter time we see South in front 2-5 to 2-2. Half-time, South LA well in front, 8-7 to 3-3. And at three-quarter time, it's still the Panthers, 11-11, Norwood 6-6.
Yes, and the goal score is there. Steckel 5, Cameron 2, Woodlands 2. And for the Red Legs, Bowman 3 and Zealand on for only that quarter, kicking 2.
Rick, I thought there was more urgency about Norwood's game in that third quarter. They looked a better side.
Well, going in at half-time, Neil Craig would have been very concerned. I've seen them come back from 6 or 7 goals down. There was a lot more urgency, but South settled, Ken, didn't they? Kicking 3 also. Yep.
Graham Campbell's on the boundary. He missed the 1-10 Woodlands, a boy that's had a couple of nasty knee injuries. If he can stay sound, he's going to be a very good player for South Adelaide.
Well, Ken, he's a whole different player this year to what I saw last year, Craig Woodlands. He's an opportunist, we all know that. But he's back to the packs tonight. He's taken a lot of physical risks and has paid off for him. His handball has been exemplary, and a couple of goals that quarter just put the stamp on his play for the night. He's looking good, Craig Woodlands. Should have a big year.
Well, Graham, the big thing about him is the fact that he kicks goals from a half-forward flank. He's a specialist.
Yes, Ken, and also he's sharing the ball. Perhaps in the past you could criticise Craig Woodlands for shooting for what you might call impossible goals. Not tonight. He's feeding it out, and a credit to John Reid's coaching, quite frankly. And the whole South Adelaide side, as a unit, is a very assured and deliberate team tonight and look good.
And Graham, what about Big Bone? He looks very good. He can take the ball in front of his eyes.
Well, any wonder that the Crows have added him to their 52-man squad. Randall Bone is a player of some quality, Rick, and just shows you the people up there know what they're doing. He's a young lad, plenty of size in his body, backs into a pack, holds his ground well, and more importantly, can take a mark.
Graham, I made mention to Rick that there was more urgency about Norwood's game in that third quarter, and I thought Zealand at centre-half forward was the key to it.
Well, perhaps, Ken, but just the general attacking of the player with the ball. Norwood in the second quarter lost their way, but in that third term, really put pressure on South and made them perhaps get a bit hesitant in some of their movements, and all of a sudden were back in the game for one glorious moment during that third quarter. Even when Michael Ace missed that mark, they mopped it up, got the ball out to the boy you mentioned, Zealand. He kicked the goal. 2 for the quarter for Andrew Zealand. Certainly gave him a chance to have a say in this game.
And also, Graham, up till tonight, perhaps David Steckel's form hasn't been that flash in the Foundation Cup, but 5-1 from full forwards, a great performance.
Oh, Steckel is really a class player, Ken, and really he should still be part of the Crows' setup, I believe, anyhow. They let him go too quickly. He really is the second full forward in this state. And if Scotty Hodges, something happens there, who do they play? It should be David Steckel, and he's certainly showing that tonight. If you remember a couple of weeks ago, Ken, they played him in the back line. And John Reid told me after the match it was only a ploy to get him away from being hounded all the time by backline players. He requested to get away from the forward line. He's gone back there now with a fresh lease of life, looking $1 million.
And Graham, really, when you're looking at it, Smart going to centre half back. He looked like a fish out of water up forward.
Yep. I don't think he's a forward, quite frankly, Rick. He's playing permanent forward pocket too, which is a terrible spot to play. The ball comes in 3 or 4 times. If you miss it, you're dead. As a backline player, he can make the play. He's all right. He'll be okay, Nigel Smart.
Good on you, Graham. Now, Rick, how did you tip before the game?
I tipped South.
Did you?
Yes, I certainly did. You try to put the wood on me. You really are. I tipped South. I didn't think they'd win by this much. Although Norwood showed a bit of urgency. Could come back, Ken, couldn't they?
Yes, they are.
Or can they come back?
Well, they will come back. And there's, of course, the finals special rule that timekeepers will be instructed to allow the game to continue if scores are tied at full time. The first team to score after full time will be the absolute winner. OK, let's now take you back to your commentator, Kim Dillon.
Thanks, Ken, Rick and Graham. Norwood trailed by 5 points at quarter time, 34 points at half time. They now trail by 35 points. And, well, they're like the boy pushing the cart. They have the job ahead of them at the moment. Umpire Laurie Argent puts ball to ground. He's officiating with umpire Richard Williams. The tap was won by Michael Thompson for Norwood, but it's the Panthers once more who take it out of centre. And that's a classic grab by Cameron. And for one fleeting moment, he thought about playing on. His best game since coming to South Adelaide. Kicking from about 60 metres out. It's a nice-looking kick. Puts it up high. Big leap from behind. Brockhurst, well, he took it uncontested. Warhurst looks behind and says, where was the support? He was looking after Steckel. And Brockhurst said, thanks very much.
Well, the difference in South Adelaide, Brockhurst, look at that. Just simple as ABC and really looked the part up forward.
He has kicked one goal. That was in the second term. And you can make that 2.
Well, at the start of the season, Johnny Reid would have been thinking to himself, well, we performed pretty well last year. We've got a number of players, Brockhurst, Naley, Cameron. I think they've recruited possibly the best of any other club. And tonight, in the grand final of this Foundation Cup, all players that they've recruited across here have performed and performed well. And South Adelaide this year are going to be a very, very good side. They're fit. They've got players all over the ground and they will perform.
South 12-11, Norwood 6-6, and we've only played 1.5 minutes into the final term of the 1991 Foundation Cup Grand Final. Norwood towards centre-half forward, stolen by Kapler. Kapler to Troy, he's going to be a very good player for the Panthers this year. He's played superbly tonight towards half-forward. Halfpenny used the body, pushed Cameron under the ball, but Cameron, good presence there. Oh, that's beautiful movement by South Adelaide. Don't tell me he's going to kick a goal, Woodland. Super stuff by the Panthers.
Well, it's raining goals here at Footy Park, and Woodlands, is he ever having a night off? He has not done a thing wrong. And you look at Cameron here, the ball bounces over. He sees the South Adelaide player in the open. Dewhurst gets hold of the football. He, in turn, streams down the ground, and Stokel, very, very good team play, holding out Warhurst, and another goal to the Panthers.
Back centre field and the Panthers march on their merry way. 13 goals, 11. Norwood, 6 goals, 6. Richard Williams with the football. And the ball is tapped down towards Aish. He got it out towards McIntosh. He's tackled. It's stolen by Naley. Play on the call. Players just stood there momentarily. It's taken by Winton. He kicks it around his body. Which way will the ball bounce? Well, look at this. It's a race for pace. Who'll be there first? It's Zimmerman. And he managed to just save the day. But at the end of the day, I don't think that'll be good enough.
Very good play by South Adelaide, all up forward. And young Zimmerman there, he didn't have much option but to push the ball through.
A kick off by Warhurst, back towards the grandstand side. Thompson almost the mark. Working hard is Thompson in there for the football. It's scrambling play at the moment. Tanner, tackled by Bickley. And umpire Williams will finally call for a bounce. It's inside the 50 for the Panthers, who've played brilliant football tonight. Umpire tonight, a Laurie Argent, and that man on your screen, Richard Williams. A promising young umpire, who I think will be the first SA umpire to umpire in the AFL. Aish, has he won a free kick? Yes, he has. Michael Aish, back towards centre wing, looking for Lachlan Bowman. Pushed away by Dillon. Baddams kept it in play. Kicked it off the ground, his good intelligent thinking, towards Zimmerman. And the ball goes out of play.
A bit of pressure by the South Adelaide players. Number 11 there in your screen, young Baddams. God, has he ever had a night on. Grant Tanner, one of the Crows members. And I think you'll find the young fella Tanner, or Baddams especially, has won the night.
Yes, he's been opposed to Mello as he picks up another possession, and that's about his 21st for the night. The ball comes to ground, picked up by Cameron. He's been an absolute star this evening. It's a good hand pass to the running player in Bennett. He lines up the goals, and the captain should have converted there.
Well, he's been a bit absent tonight. He hasn't done a lot of work. He's done a number of quick plays there across that centre line. But on that occasion, a beautiful hand pass by Cameron, and should have finished the playoff.
Played 4.5 minutes into the final term of the grand final of the Foundation Cup for 1991. Over the top, Thompson, casual mark by the youngster. Gave a handball away, put the player under an enormous amount of pressure. That was Zimmerman. Back to Halfpenny. Over to Tanner. Tanner puts Norwood into attack. Pack goes high. Ross from behind. Couldn't complete the mark. Taken by Dillon to Page. Page finds a player with his left boot, which is Baddams. Baddams up towards half-forward. Cameron's a player he's looking for. Inside the 50. Supported by Bennett, his captain. Centres the football up towards full-forward. The Panthers go. Off hands, almost a chance for Winton. Loves to kick goals. The kick is smothered. That occasion by Pike, and the ball forces its way out of play.
Well, when the play goes out to number 13 for South Adelaide, the bull, you can hear the crowd go up, bull, bull, bull. But unfortunately, it was smothered on that occasion.
Coach Neil Craig has made a move. He's swapped wings. He's put Tanner onto Baddams as Woodlands lines up, waves his arm in the air. A little prematurely, as he missed. He thought he'd kick that.
Well, Kim, you'd have to say tonight, number 16, Craig Woodhams and Cameron, have either been doing something right at work or training during the week, because the ball has just followed those two players continually all night.
You're right there, Rick. And as I mentioned or was saying earlier, on the other wing now, Mello is opposed to Dewhurst as the ball is put into attack once more, but the mark has been taken by Zimmerman. He kicks it long after the players I was talking about. Tanner, who takes the mark. He will try and curb the effect that Matthew Baddams has had on this game from his wing. He puts the ball up to centre-half forward. Sheldrick, in fact, Zealand playing centre-half forward, opposed to Bone. The loose ball goes out towards Smart. And doesn't he like running straight at the football? That long, loping strike. He drives it in. Steckel opposed to Warhurst. The big fist comes from Tommy Warhurst, but it's picked up by Cameron. He's offline. He kicked something like 2.4 tonight.
He's playing absolutely superbly, and you can see there, young fellow, obviously not a South Adelaide supporter, as he'd be jumping over the fence. But let's see if Norwood can kick four or five goals.
South Adelaide 13-15, Norwood 6-6. We're almost 7 minutes into the final term. Cameron, good tackle then on that occasion, almost holding the ball. Goes the way of Troy. Heavy bodywork. Naley's in there. Bennett, the tackler. McIntosh, scrambling football. Finally comes out to Tanner. Back now. The North Adelaide through Zimmerman, Norwood should I say, to Zimmerman, back towards centre wing, Dillon, and the ball is forced out of play, centre wing, grandstand side.
South Adelaide have certainly got some good young players. Dillon winning the award a couple of years ago, or last year. He's been in sensational form so far this year. Whitford, let's hope that he hasn't got too bad an injury, because his performance at centre-half backhand's very good.
It certainly is a good player, doesn't he? Isn't he trying to get too many kicks? Bickley, this young man's had a good night too, throws it out the way of Bennett. Bennett centres the football. A chance back here for Norwood through Warhurst. Oh, stolen by Woodlands. Woodlands back to Whitten. This is home. Jeff Whitten into an open goal, and the Bulls kick one.
That's a couple of goals for the Bull. And South Adelaide, they're going to be a very, very hard side. I mentioned a couple of minutes ago that they're going to be, have got the players in which to perform. But Woodlands tonight, the ball is just thoroughly bounced his way. He's made position, there's no question about that. And if you've got to be a goal scorer, you've got to make position. But then in that particular instance, Winton in the right spot and put through their 14th.
Jeffrey Winton kicks his first goal for the evening and moves South Adelaide along to 14 goals, 15. Norder on 6-6 as Page takes the ball in defence and transfers the ball out wide to find Dewhurst. Craig Dewhurst, one of the more seasoned players for South Adelaide. Kick number 8. The mark's been taken by Binder. He started the game in fine fashion. He's been a little bit quiet since. Looking for Zealand, he couldn't take it. In there is Page. The ball flicks out towards Smart. Smart kicks around his body. Back underneath it is Winton, opposed to the other number 13 in Pike. And the mark has been paid for the ball.
Yes, certainly. He got in the right spot. He got in the front spot. And he'd be really looking forward to impress tonight again. He's been quite impressive in these Foundation Cup games for next week's first opening game.
Naley the handball, pushing the ball forward. It now goes out towards Baddams. He in turn puts it out towards Cameron. He makes a little bit of space. He perhaps could be best man on the ground as he kicks another point to give himself a personal tally of 2-5.
8:30, Super 66, and Saturday Crossroads draws at 8:33, National 9 Newsbreak. And at 8:35, a special time for Hey Hey, It's Saturday.
Well, if I was Craig Woodlands or Gary Cameron, I'd be going out to buy a cross lotto ticket, because they have had an absolute day on today. I would have thought that their luck would be right in.
You never know. As Ace takes the ball, chips it in, looking for Bowman, who takes the mark. Now, Lachlan Bowman has kicked 3 goals this evening out of Norwood 6.
Well, if anything's come out of the Norwood side tonight, I know they've been, well, pretty soundly beaten all over the ground, but this young man, 5 marks and 9 kicks, he's been very, very good up forward, very, very strong mark.
He kicked 2 in the first, 1 in the second, and he has kicked 1 in this final term.
Well, I mentioned a couple of seconds ago, and here's Michael Ash on the screen, always doing something with the ball. He hasn't done a lot tonight. Good work there by Muster. He kept the South Adelaide player out. A bit stuttery on the kick, but a beautiful kick for goal all the same, and after a lovely mark.
Well, South Adelaide 14-16, Norwood 7-6. A great performance by the Panthers, and we're 11 minutes into the final quarter as we see Smart coming out of defence since being moved there. He's played superbly. Doesn't kick well with his left foot. Back towards Bennett. Centre wing. Over to Winton. Put him under the hammer, but done beautifully by Michael Bennett. Gee whiz, Their use of the football tonight by the Panthers has been superb. Over the top of Warhurst, picked up by Binder. He has a paddock in which to run in, has his second bounce, looks for options further afield, and goes the way of Thomas. Troy was in front, over the top to Zealand. He dropped the football, picked up by Smart. Back towards Heath, he can't do much with it. In goes Froggy Murdoch, but in the interim, a free kick has been paid. It'll go the way of Heath. Heath with a handball to Bickley. Bickley over to Baddams. They'll be in strife here. Over towards Bennett. Back to Baddams. They're playing with North Adelaide at the moment, the Panthers. Towards, to Norwood, should I say. Over towards half forward. And the mark has been taken by Winton.
Well, back in the centre of the ground, I think you'll find that Troy's just had a bit of a shoulder injury. And I think the other player over there for Norwood is Keith Thomas. A bit of a clash there. And both players haven't come off too well.
And a warm round of applause for Darren Troy as he leaves the ground. He was victorious over Gary McIntosh in their centre duel. Onto the ground is Darryl Hewitt as Bickley lines up the goals. It is an accurate kick, and South Adelaide have booted their 15th goal.
Well, let's hope that Darren Troy hasn't suffered a bad shoulder injury. He walked off pretty well on the ball after taking a beautiful mark through Winton and Bickley. Got a number of touches tonight. Been a very, very good player. 7 kicks and 14 handballs. He's been shoveling the ball out all night. And a magnificent goal to finish the playoff.
And look at that scoreboard. 15-16, Norwood 7-6. The Panthers in front. Norwood, Tanner, taken by Winton to Bickley. He's a very strong player. Kicks towards centre-half forward. Working hard. And there is Sheldrick, tackled. Halfpenny, Woodlands, very good player for South. Now that's champagne stuff over towards Cameron. His handball wasn't good, put the player under pressure, and as a consequence, a ball in the scrimmage. Umpire Laurie Argent there, and the attendance tonight, very good indeed. 17,212, and the league would be tickle pink with that. As the bounce down, a chance for Mellor, kicked off the ground by Dewhurst. Steckle. Naley is there, Warhurst the tackler. Steckle did it well, but handball straight to Mellor. Mellor has been penalised, I think, for a throw. Well, how about that, Rick?
Big Steckle handballed the ball straight to Mellor, and the umpire's given Mellor's handball to another Norwood player a throw.
That lady is still knitting. It's unbelievable. But tonight, she's obviously enjoyed the game here. The action with Steckle. Very acute angle. Kicks. Has he kicked accurately? No, I think he's missed. Only a minor score to Steckle. South Adelaide go to 15-17. Norwood 7-6.
That's blotted the coffee book a little bit, but just goes to show you what Norwood's luck has been like tonight. They can't even get away with an easy play.
107 points opposed to 48, and the mark has been taken out there by Dewhurst. We've had just over 14 minutes of the final term. It will be a South Adelaide victory. They have a huge marquee erected at Panther Park for supporters to get back there. And join in the success of this 1991 Foundation Cup victory. Because there is no way in the world Norwood can get back into this game. They trail with something like 8-11.
Very important, Kim, for Norwood. I know they might not be able to get back into this game, but it's very important they finish this game off with a little bit of vigour and just try and get a couple of plays together, because the competition's not far away, the real live competition.
It's a fair comment, Rick, as the ball is punched away. Down there is Thompson. Dewhurst gets another handball. It's out towards Naley. He weaves his way through a host of Norwood players. Eventually, the ball goes out towards Kapler. Kapler, in turn, puts it out wide, and he finds Bickley. This will be kick number 8. He's had 14 handballs. He's kicked 1 goal. And this time, he has found Steckle. The mark's been paid. He plays on. And he's missed it. Perhaps just rushed his work a bit then, Rick.
Well, I think he thought that the ball was going to be out on the full. And from here, looking at the screen, I think you'll find that it may have been. And let's hope that Michael Whitford there on your screen with the bad knee is all right.
And that ball did appear to go out of bounds on the full, but the kick in by Warhurst comes back towards the grandstand side. Heath, McIntosh and Sheldrick back towards Tanner. Well, Tanner threw it away to no one in particular. It's taken by Heath. He in turn gave it to Zimmerman. Back to Heath. They're sharing the football at the moment as Baddams goes into the pocket. Looking out there for Winton. Hanging on the first bounce. Pirouettes beautifully. Gives a handball off. That was super stuff by Winton. Steckle puts it up into the square. Going back is the ball. Crashes it back to Woodlands. Well, I tell you
what, when you're hot, you're hot. Four goals to Woodlands.
Played by Michael Bennett. Gee whiz, the use of the football tonight by the Panthers has been superb. Over the top of Warhurst, picked up by Binder. He has a paddock in which to run in, has his second bounce, looks for options further afield, and goes the way of Thomas. Troy was in front, over the top to Zealand. He dropped the football, picked up by Smart. Back towards Heath, he can't do much with it. In goes Froggy Murdoch, but in the interim, a free kick has been paid. It'll go the way of Heath. Heath with a handball to Bickley. Bickley over to Baddams. I'll be in strife here. Over towards Bennett, back to Baddams. They're playing with North Adelaide at the moment, the Panthers. Towards, to Norwood, should I say, over towards half forward, and the mark has been taken by Winton.
If you're back in the centre of the ground, I think you'll find that Troy's just had a bit of a shoulder injury. And I think the other player over there for Norwood is Keith Thomas. A bit of a clash there, and both players haven't come off too well.
And a warm round of applause for Darren Troy as he leaves the ground. He was victorious over Gary McIntosh in their centre duel. Onto the ground is Darryl Hewitt as Bickley lines up the goals. It is an accurate kick, and South Adelaide have booted their 15th goal.
Well, let's hope that Darren Troy hasn't suffered a bad shoulder injury. He walked off pretty well in the ball after taking a beautiful mark through Winton and Bickley. Got a number of touches tonight. Been a very, very good player. 7 kicks and 14 handballs. He's been shoveling the ball out all night. And a magnificent goal to finish the playoff.
And look at that scoreboard. 15-16, Norwood 7-6. The Panthers in front. Norwood, Tanner. Taken by Winton to Bickley. He's a very strong player. Kicks towards centre-half forward. Working hard. And there is Sheldrick. Tackled. Halfpenny. Woodlands. Very good player for South. Now that's champagne stuff over towards Cameron. His handball wasn't good. Put the player under pressure. And as a consequence, a ball in the scrimmage. Umpire Laurie Argent there. And the attendance tonight, very good indeed. 17,212. And the league would be tickle pink with that. As the bounce down, a chance for Mellor, kicked off the ground by Dewhurst. Steckle, Naley is there, Warhurst the tackler. Steckle did it well, but handball straight to Mellor. Mellor has been penalised, I think, for a throw. Well, how about that, Rick?
Big Steckle handballed the ball straight to Mellor, and the umpire's given Mellor's handball to another Norwood player a throw.
That lady is still knitting. It's unbelievable. But tonight, she's obviously enjoyed the game here. The action with Steckle. Very acute angle. Kicks. Has he kicked accurately? No, I think he's missed. Only a minor score to Steckle. South Adelaide go to 15-17. Norwood 7-6.
That's blotted the copybook a little bit, but just goes to show you what Norwood's luck has been like tonight. They can't even get away with an easy play.
107 points opposed to 48. The mark has been taken out there by Dewhurst. We've had just over 14 minutes of the final term. It will be a South Adelaide victory. They have a huge marquee erected at Panther Park for supporters to get back there and join in the success of this 1991 Foundation Cup victory. Because there is no way in the world Norwood can get back into this game. They trail with something like 8-11.
Very important, Kim, for Norwood. I know they might not be able to get back into this game, but it's very important they finish this game off with a little bit of vigour and just try and get a couple of plays together, because the competition's not far away, the real live competition.
It's a fair comment, Rick, as the ball is punched away. Down there is Thompson. Dewhurst gets another handball. It's out towards Naley. He weaves his way through a host of Norwood players. Eventually the ball goes out towards Kapler. Kapler in turn puts it out wide and he finds Bickley. This will be kick number 8. He's had 14 handballs. He's kicked one goal. And this time he has found Steckle. The mark's been paid. He plays on. And he's missed it. Perhaps just rushed his work a bit then, Rick.
Well, I think he thought that the ball was going to be out on the full. And from here, looking at the screen, I think you'll find that it may have been. Let's hope that Michael Whitford there on your screen with the bad knee is all right.
And that ball did appear to go out of bounds on the full, but a kick in by Warhurst comes back towards the grandstand side. Heath, McIntosh and Sheldrick back towards Tanner. Well, Tanner threw it away to no one in particular. It's taken by Heath. He in turn gave it to Zimmerman. Back to Heath. They're sharing the football at the moment as Batham goes into the pocket, looking out there for Winton. Taken on the first bounce. Pirouettes beautifully. Gives a handball off.
That was super stuff by Whedon. Steckle puts it up into the square. Going back is the ball. Crashes it back to Woodlands. Well, I tell you what, when you're hot, four goals to Woodlands.
Well, Ken, when you're saying that when you're hot, you're hot. South Adelaide have just had a number of players tonight. You can see the desperation from Winton there. He not only got the football out on the half-forward flank, he ran back to try and mark it again and almost did. And that's the desperation that South Adelaide have shown tonight. They've been all over the place. And the joy there of number 16, Woodlands. He has had an absolute picnic tonight.
South 16-18, Norwood 7-6. Woodlands kicking the last goal for the Panthers, courtesy of the bulldozer who cleared the pack. Thompson gets the ball out. But legging free kick will go the way of the youngster. Michael Thompson started on the interchange bench. We've not seen John Hall in the second half, which begs the question whether he's injured or not, as the mark is taken by David Payne. Now, he was a real live wire in the first term, but he's been quiet since. That is kick number 15. In fact, the first half he was a pretty useful player, but the second half it really has been all South Adelaide.
Well, let's just hope that Norwood don't lose any confidence out of this, because they've been a young, vibrant side. They've been all over the place. They've got younger players that we haven't seen before performing, and let's hope that they don't lose too much out of this game.
Don't forget, coming up after the Foundation Cup Grand Final, Hey Hey, It's Saturday, with Darryl Summers, and the captain, Michael Bennett, has left the arena, and one of the most courageous players in South Australian football, Peter McCarty, is onto the ground, and that free kick was for holding the ball, and the recipient is Jonathan Ross, and this may be his first kick for the evening. It is, and a very quiet player, and we mentioned a few weeks ago, Ken, he has to do more than just try and take the big mark, got to move around and get more involved in the game. Left foot kick is accurate, he's posted his first goal.
Well, let's hope that the South Adelaide side, who have been renowned over the last couple of years, or the last 5 years, to be winning these Foundation Cup games, and they come out and they don't win any of the home and away games. A couple of years ago, Woodville did exactly the same, and Johnny Reid, he'd be pretty happy. And Ian Borchardt, just there with the blue jumper behind him, he would also be encouraged by the year coming up.
Yes, it's going to be a big year for the Panthers, that is for sure. They've got some very useful players, quick players, and tall timber. And they're going to be a force in the league football again in 1991. Winton, the kick came from McCarty. The handball was searching for Bickley, couldn't find that player. Zimmerman kicks back towards the centre of the ground. Tapped on. Taken by Murdoch, back towards Keith Thomas. Thomas now from centre wing up towards centre half forward. Ace in front of the pack looking to crumb the football. Taken by Zeeland. Kicks off the side of the boot into the pocket. Page getting back there. So is Drummond, and takes a very strong mark. Drummond will go short. In fact, he's kicked into the man on the mark. Well, that's a free kick to a Norwood player. And it appears to be Jonathan Ross. Jonathan Ross with the free kick.
Drummond there taking the ball with a magnificent mark. Saw Dewhurst out on the outer side, and it was good work by Jonathan Ross to smother.
Ross from an almost an impossible angle. Looks for options. There aren't too many forthcoming. He's going to go for a banana kick. It was not a bad kick, I can tell you. What's the goal umpire done? I think he may have kicked it. Well, what a great goal by Jonathan Ross.
Well, a little bit of confidence there by the young fellow. He's had a dark night, you might say. Beaten very, very convincingly in that first quarter. And you can see there that McGrummett coming right over the top of the young bloke. Looked at the options, then thought, well, perhaps I can kick this myself. Decided to go for the hardest kick of the night with a banana ball and put through a very, very good goal.
The Red Legs endeavouring to put some respectability onto the scoreboard. They move along to 9-6, South Adelaide 16-18. It's been a very polished and professional performance by the Panthers. There were a lot of peas in there as Heath picks up the ball. Goes down towards Thomas. He has been a quiet player. In there is Sheldrick. Had four goals kicked on him when standing Steckle. Now the ball put down towards Page. Too much pace for Aish. Now the handball is a long one along the boundary line, and we'll have a throw in on that outer side.
This goes to show you the South Adelaide desperation all night. They've had players all over the ground. Dylan, you can mention all of the players. Smart back there since he's been back there. Has just absolutely stopped Zeeland. Just when Norwood seemed to get a bit of a run on, South Adelaide can come back, and that's the sign of a good side.
David Payne has the football, kick number 16, puts it up towards centre half forward. Dylan underneath it, couldn't take it. Back there is Smart, couldn't pick the ball up cleanly. Now he sockers it off the ground, and he's happy with that result. And Rick, the important factor is the fact that South Adelaide also have a lot of depth on the in their club at the moment. We have a look, Hewitt coming onto the ground. He's no spring chicken, but he is a good footballer. And young Peter McCarty also, who was on the bench.
Yes, there's a number of players back there that, you know, that are league standard players. But, you know, you don't need too many injuries. Like, if Troy's got a little bit of a bad injury and they just cop a couple, they need those players coming back and performing. And we look at Winton. He's another one, a player that doesn't get a regular game, and everyone loves him when he comes onto the ground.
Keith Thomas now puts the legs back into attack towards centre-half for David Payne. Crumbed it well, but gave away a shocking handball. McCarty gives it the way of Nigel Smart. Picked it up very well indeed. Goes the way of Dewhurst. On the defensive side of centre, looks for Heath at centre wing, and a strong mark by the youngster. He'll put the Panthers into attack. 22 minutes gone, the final quarter. South Adelaide, a very impressive side. That's not a good kick from Heath, taken by Thompson. The ball is forced out of play. South Adelaide into attack. South 16-18, 114, Norwood 9-6-60. And the scoreboard tells the story of the performance tonight by the Panthers. Over the top was Thompson, a good tap, taken by Sheldrick, at the way of Payne. Payne to Halfpenny. Binder running out of defence towards half forward. Thumped away by Smart. Good defensive work. Then runs away with the footy. Back towards centre it goes. Getting under his Woodlands. He's had the ball fairing him on a string tonight. Craig Woodlands, the former Glenelg player. Into the forward area goes. And that's poor defensive work by Norwood. And Bickley takes the mark.
Difference between South Adelaide's performance tonight, as I see it, they haven't just wasted the ball. Every time that South Adelaide players up forward of the ground have looked down and into the forward lines, they've put the ball to advantage. And that was just typical of what they've been doing all night.
10 kicks to Bickley. He's kicked one goal. This is goal number two. Straight over the top of the goal umpire's head. It's home, South Adelaide's 17th goal.
Well, South Adelaide supporters would be absolutely thrilled with this performance. I know they've got a wedding back at the South Adelaide Rooms. There in your screen is the Foundation Cup they'll be taking back to St Mary's tonight, and I would say that there would be a real shindig back at South Adelaide Pantherland tonight, and they certainly deserve it. They've been the better side all night.
Great to hear that country terminology, Rick. Shindig. Bounce centre field. The tap is won by Thompson. In there is Baddams. So too Hewitt. Likewise Payne. The handball out from Pike went straight back to Hewitt. He kicks it higher than he has longer. Players get underneath it. McCarty won't budge. He was up high. Taken by Winton. One bounce. He kicked one goal. The crowd starts shouting, bull, 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 as he lines up. But he's just offline. And it's players like that, Rick, that really do make the game.
Well, it certainly is. And he is a character. There's no question about that. He doesn't shirk the issue. He runs straight at the football. And, well, I suppose he's a little bit disappointed when he doesn't get picked.
Yeah, Jumbo, he doesn't shirk the issue, that's for sure. Thumped away by Heath. Halfpenny looking for Tannard. It's a good handball. Tannard on the defensive side of centre, back towards centre wing. Good defensive work by Smart. Did it cleverly, then runs away with good pace. A long kick towards centre half forward. The football goes, thumped away. Taken by Woodlands again. It must be his football, surely. Which way will it bounce? Not the right way for South Adelaide. And through for Aimwine to score.
With Smart playing at centre half back. Any wonders that he started there, Ken, that it wouldn't have got past the half-forward line as it was?
No, he loved playing in defence, that's for sure. 4-3, Woodlands has kicked tonight. Not a bad performance. And there's the siren. And it's the Panthers by 62 points in the grand final of the Foundation Cup.
Well, they've performed brilliantly tonight. In your screen, number 16, Mark Naley's come back from Carlton, performed brilliantly tonight. And Michael Bennett, the captain of the side, he'd be a very, very happy man. And let's face it, South Adelaide, well, last year they had a huge financial problems. Everything seemed to be down in the doldrums. They've come up, they've put big Harry down there, Harry Kernahan, to manage the club. They've got a number of players back. The confidence has really turned, and you can see there all the South Adelaide players congratulating one another. They've performed magnificently tonight. They've been the better side. They've had players up forward. And congratulations to Johnny Reid.
lead well. What a performance, John. You must be absolutely delighted with that four-quarter effort by your boys.
Yeah, good team effort for the whole game, Graeme. And, yeah, very pleased. And the boys have worked hard early, so we've got some rewards. But tomorrow morning, mate, we start a new campaign.
So John again next week. John, I've got to ask you, when did you relax? When did you think you had it won?
Oh, I thought about the eight-minute mark of the last quarter, we had it pretty well under control.
You start to smile?
Yeah, I did a bit. Yeah, it was good. Good to me. I was really pleased. Young Randall Bone was a really good performance. And so all round, it was good.
John, marvellous performance, and best of luck the rest of the season.
Thank you very much.
Well, it certainly was a magnificent performance. And there you see the scoreboard at quarter time. South Adelaide led 2-5 to 2-2. A bigger lead at half time. The Panthers 8-7 to 3-3. They won the game virtually in the third quarter. 11-11 to the legs 6-6. And the final scoreline, look at that. In the grand final of the Foundation Cup, 17 goals, 20, 122, Norwood 9660.
And the all-important goal kickers for the Red Legs, Bowman kicked 4, Zeeland and Ross 2 apiece. And for South Adelaide, Steckel kicked 5, Woodlands 4, Cameron, Bickley, Brockhurst all kicked 2 goals.
Well, we certainly hope you've enjoyed our coverage of the Foundation Cup, in particular, of course, the grand final tonight between Norwood and South Adelaide. There you see a very happy group of South Adelaide players. And they deserve their win tonight, being clearly the better side. But Norwood certainly not disgraced. They've had a very, very good year in the Foundation Cup, and they can look forward to a very promising 1991 under their coach, the new coach, Neil Craig. He's done a top job with Norwood so far as the Foundation Cup is concerned. The prize money, South Adelaide, $17,000 tonight, and Norwood taking home $10,000. So we certainly hope you've enjoyed our coverage of the grand final here at Football Park. It came to you via Nine's Wide World of Sports.